Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Hello and welcome to the Alex Jones Show. This is Mike Adams, the Health Ranger, filling in for Alex, who's working on other projects today. The guy never quits working, super busy. We've got a huge lineup of news for you today. The world continues to veer towards insanity, it seems. We've got three, maybe even four, hard-hitting guests lined up for you throughout the show today, including James Stewart, and Rawsome Foods is now history. It has been disassembled, sold off, sanitized, eliminated from California. So the bureaucrats there think they've won a victory. We're going to have James Stewart talking about that. But even bigger issues, what this means for America and the government's assault on farms and food freedom. I want to thank you for joining me today. I really put the word out about this show and the focus on the government's assault on farms and food freedom. But of course, we're going to cover much more than that. In the third hour, for example, we have attorney Dale Carson joining us. He's a former FBI agent and also a former South Miami cop. He's the author of a book called Arrest Proof Yourself. He's an expert on how to not get arrested, which is a very important skill today, given that the police are sometimes anxious to throw people behind bars. And we're going to find out why. It turns out there is kind of a point system, a tally system that they use where their careers advance. If they can arrest you for a felony crime, even if you never get convicted of it, the cop still gets the points or the tally for having made that arrest, regardless of the merits of that arrest. So Dale Carson will be joining us in the third hour. In the second hour also, we've got Mark Baker from bakersgreenacres.com. He is the farmer whose pigs are threatened with being shot by the authorities in the state of Michigan, who have decided that now all these backyard pigs are so-called feral pigs, and they've threatened to go in and destroy these herds, these livestock all across the state. So we're going to have some thoughts from him. He's a veteran of the United States Air Force, and many veterans are getting extremely frustrated and wanting to speak out more about what they see as government intimidation and tyranny and oppression aimed at them. Now, in another case that exemplifies the abuse of government power against American citizens, we're also going to be covering the breaking news that's just up today about Andrew Wurdies. He's the backyard chicken man from Roswell, Georgia. And Andrew took his life, set himself on fire, set his house on fire with himself in it just, what, 2 weeks ago, roughly. March 26th, I believe, was the day, after being intimidated, oppressed, abused by government authorities there in Roswell, Georgia for many years. We've got a timeline of events, how the bureaucrats there escalated the events and threw him in jail and resulted in his home being looted, his chickens being poisoned, all his valuables being stolen, and then they tried to take his land as a green zone, even though they are the ones who were causing the flooding that affected his land. We're going to have that story, more details for you on that coming up right here on the Alex Jones Show. Plus, all that and other breaking news. We've got news about the MIT prediction of the post-industrial crash of the human population. Alex covered that a bit yesterday. We'll go into more details on that today. We've got dental x-rays linked to brain cancer. We've got the natural health products bill in New Zealand that would now criminalize you for making a cup of herbal tea. That's right, a $50,000 fine for brewing up a cup of herbal tea in New Zealand. So you see, this oppression of medical freedom is happening everywhere around the world. We've got more news on the honeybee population collapse. I know Alex covered that a bit yesterday. We'll go into a little more detail. News about pink slime, how to survive the modern world in the event of a crisis, and much more. All of that is straight ahead here on the Alex Jones Show. So don't go away. We will be right back after this break. Stay with us.
I- I had tried everything. I'd cut back the amount of food I was eating. I was lifting weights and jogging, but nothing was working. My body was literally starving for minerals and trace elements as well as key vitamins. And as soon as I had that, I immediately could eat half of what I was eating previously and be satisfied. Now, there are hundreds of great products at InfoWarsTeam.com, but I want to point out the three that have helped me lose 37 pounds in just 2 months. Products like Beyond Tangy Tangerine, Pollen Burst, and Rebound. When I started taking the Tangy Tangerine and other products every day, I lost more than 37 pounds in just 2 months. Now that's results. I want to challenge my listeners to go to InfoWarsTeam.com and to order just three of their products, and you will see the changes in the way you look, feel, and in your appetite almost immediately. Start your journey to health and wellness today. InfoWarsTeam.com.
Hi, this is Alex Jones. Did you know that the global elite are now storing non-hybrid seeds in secret storage vaults near the Arctic Circle? Did you know that in a real meltdown, non-hybrid seeds can become more valuable than silver or gold? It's true, seeds have outperformed even gold and silver before in this country, and it's possible that could even happen again. So our friends at Solutions from Science have put together the perfect mix of non-hybrid seeds. They call it a survival seed bank, and it can produce an endless supply of nutrient-dense food for you and your family. And here's the best part. These seeds have not been genetically modified in any way, and you actually get enough seeds to plant a full acre crisis garden. So visit them today at survivalseedbank.com. That's survivalseedbank.com, or give them a call at 877-327-0365. That's 877-327-0365. Remember, in a real crisis, non-hybrid seeds are the ultimate barter item. This is Alex Jones for SurvivalSeedBank.com.
Right now, the average family spends 1/4 of their income on food. It's time to cut your food budget in half by using the best, most affordable food on the planet from eFoods Direct. The savings from eating this food will actually help you pay your other bills. Serve these delicious meals to your family tonight for a quick and easy dinner for about $1.25 a serving, compared to over $3 a serving for any other food. This food is compact, making it easy to store some away, and will be just as delicious in 25 years as the ones you cook tonight. Is it affordable? Absolutely. The new Alex Jones Family Pack saves you up to 50% compared to other food storage companies. See the comparison at eFoodsDirect.com/Alex or call 800-409-5633. My friends, as crazy as this world is today, you'd be nuts to not get a storable food supply. Give eFoods Direct a call and order one of the Alex Jones Family Packs and test it out today. Start your journey of food independence today at eFoodsDirect.com/Alex or call 800-409-5633.
He's the T-Rex of political talk. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. It is Tuesday, April 10th, 2012. This is Mike Adams, the Health Ranger, sitting in for Alex today. Thank you for joining us today. We've got a huge lineup of not just great guests, but also breaking news on the freedom and liberty front. As always, pushing the boundaries of awareness and awakening so that we can help people actually stand up for their liberties and freedoms right here on the Alex Jones Show. We are... It sometimes is difficult to know where to even begin with the news. We've got, again, piles of news here. We're going to get right into it, but I want to mention the overarching theme here first. Number one, we are under chemical assault in America today. By chemical assault, I'm talking about the SSRI drugs, which Alex covered yesterday in some detail, which the LA Times even found the courage to write about the soldiers being drugged with SSRIs and other psychiatric drugs leading to violence and mayhem and murder. And that's an absolute fact. That is something that I've been harping on for years because we've seen the school shootings, we've seen the violence, we've seen the death. And normally the mainstream media doesn't even cover the psychiatric drugs that are involved. So I don't have a lot of nice things to say about the LA Times, but kudos to them for actually covering that over the last few days, and especially thumbs up to Alex for covering it here on the show. It's not just the chemical assault on humans, it's also the chemical assault on the insects. Why does that matter? You might be laughing. Why does that matter? Well, the honeybees, of course. About 1/3 of all the food that you eat is pollinated by honeybees. And without those pollinators, of course, the food supply collapses. literally just collapses in one season. And three new hard-hitting scientific studies have come out recently, within the last just couple of weeks, two of them just in the last week, that all but prove a link between these pesticides, these chemical synthetic pesticides, and the collapse of the honeybees. Now, I know there are other issues involved, such as the cell phone towers. There's electromagnetic radiation and interference and so on. GMOs probably have a role in the collapse of the honeybee populations, but now we know for sure that the pesticides do. So we have this chemical assault on humans and on insects affecting the food supply. And at the same time that's going on, we've got all the GMOs out there, which is just another form of a genetic assault on humanity. And then at the same time that's going on, we've got the Obama administration and the government attacking all of our liberties and all of our freedoms. And I believe, based on what I've been reading and the research that I've been doing, remember, I work 16-hour days at Natural News. I'm the editor there, in case you don't know. So I work just like the guys here work, Aaron Dykes and Alex Jones and Kurt Nimmo. Everybody works so hard doing the research. I believe that there is an agenda to destroy America's economy, to take over America, to centralize all the resources. I mean, we saw it with not just the attacks on the farmers, which we're going to be covering here on the show in great detail with our guests, but also with Obama signing that March 16th executive order that takes over control of the farms and the livestock and the seeds, the farming equipment, the food processing equipment, just seizing control over that. We saw the remember Senate bill last year, what was it, 501, the Food Safety and Modernization Act, that is still set to unleash a wave of inspectors all across the country to come in and start fining people and arresting people for growing gardens and having the wrong setup in their garden, in their home garden, in their farm situation. And then this story, we're going to cover this today, the city of Roswell, Georgia. A total abuse of government power that led to the death of Andrew Wurdes. Andrew was a backyard chicken farmer. He is now dead, having taken his life after being abused and tormented by the regulators there in the city of Roswell. This just makes me so sick, because this is a guy I think we could have helped if we had known about this. Remember, you've heard the saying, InfoWars saves lives, right? You know that. InfoWars covered Julie Bass, the Michigan gardener who was facing jail time. Charges were dropped. InfoWars and Natural News also especially covered Marianne Godboldo, the Detroit, Michigan mother who refused to drug her daughter with psychiatric drugs and then was subjected to a SWAT team raid. All the charges were dropped against her, even though they alleged that she fired a warning shot at the police to try to defend her home and defend her daughter. They dropped the charges. Why? Because of the public attention brought to the issue. But this man in Roswell, Georgia, Andrew Wurdes, is dead today because we didn't know about him, because we couldn't get to him quickly enough. We couldn't bring attention to this issue quickly enough. We couldn't bring attention to the bureaucrats there at the city to tell them to stop their tyranny, to stop what they're doing, to stop bullying these innocent citizens to the point where they feel like they have nothing to lose and they want to kill themselves. And this man did kill himself, Andrew Wurdes. He's dead today because of what these bureaucrats in Roswell, Georgia did to him. And we're going to go into more detail about that on the show today. And it really, I get incensed about this, because we are under assault in America. And what we saw there in Roswell, Georgia, was this example of what I called right here on the Alex Jones Show last year, trickle-down tyranny, which was when the federal government becomes tyrannical and oppressive, then those ideas, those dark, evil philosophies of stealing people's freedoms and oppressing the people and laughing about it and having fun as the people suffer, those ideas trickle down into the local municipalities. They get down to the state level. They get down to the local county level and the city level. And then those bureaucrats think, well, we can act like little devils too, that we can just oppress people and we can use our sick power, their ego-tripping, egomaniac power, to go after their political enemies, people that don't bow down to them and lick their boots. And that's what we saw in Roswell, Georgia. And that's why that man is dead today. And we see it over and over again. Here's a piece out of Courthouse News Service right here. A woman claims a cops ran off with her baby at the hospital. She was waiting for a hospital nurse to find someone to remove the hospital identification bracelet and from the baby as a last step before leaving the hospital. And then the police officers there, this is Maryland, the MPD officers appeared and, quote, forcibly separated her from her baby, causing injury to her hand. And then they ran down the corridor in the hospital with her newborn son to the nursery while blocking the mother from following her child. They then forced the mother to return to her hospital room where they stood guard so that she could not leave. She claims after about 2 hours, a nurse told her that Child Protective Services, of course, had approved the separation. You see how this works? And then she was forcibly escorted out of the hospital without her baby. You see how that works? First, they call the cops. They make up some excuse to take your baby from you. And then, they call in CPS if you don't totally go along with it. And then the CPS can take state custody of your child and force them to be vaccinated. We saw that in Pennsylvania. Just, 10 days ago, a mother was forced out of the hospital. She had to sleep in her car in a Walmart parking lot all night long so that she could then come in every few hours and breastfeed her baby, which the hospital staff and the CPS staff allowed her to breastfeed. Oh, because they're so generous. After stealing her baby and after forcing the baby to be vaccinated against the wishes and the will of the mother, they then allowed her to come back in so that she could breastfeed. Oh, aren't they so gracious? Yeah. What? How wonderful these people are. But these are the overriding themes of what we are seeing in America today. We're seeing runaway oppression, tyranny, intimidation of the people by agents of the government, both state and local and at the city level, as we mentioned. And then we're seeing this chemical assault at the same time. So these two themes, I want you to keep these in your mind as you listen to the Alex Jones Show today. We're going to see how these themes weave throughout the stories, the news, the narratives, the guests that we have on today. In every one of these cases, you're going to see these two themes becoming even more and more apparent in your mind, because this is what's happening: an assault on our freedoms, a destruction of our economy, takeover of our farms and food, and a complete government takeover of your individual rights as parents and your individual liberties, just as an individual, just as a person. I'm a little angry today, as you can probably tell. Look, I like to come in here and do satire from time to time. We do jokes sometimes, we make fun of the global elite and the New World Order. And I just, things are getting so serious. I can't even get into that space anymore. I can't find humor right now. I'm sorry. I don't know. All I feel is outrage at what's going on. And I hope and pray that we're not going to descend into some kind of violence. And we're going to have Patrick Henningsen on in the second hour. He's an Infowars.com reporter, and he's going to be talking to us about the escalation of the so-called race war. And it pains my heart to hear the talk out there of the Black Panthers and these people out there, the Al Sharptons and the Jesse Jacksons, who are spewing hate speech and inciting hatred and inciting the kind of violence that they claim to be against. And they're inciting it. And if white people were out there, or radio hosts like myself or Alex were saying those things on the radio, they'd be arrested immediately. Why is it okay for one group to say those things, but not another group? Why can't we all just chill out? We're all 99.8% genetically identical. We're all brothers and sisters, literally. It's not black versus white. You know what it is? It's the people versus the power elite, versus the corporate controllers, versus the government controllers. And they know that they win when they get you and I and people of different skin colors and people of different religions to fight against each other and start a shooting war between each other. They win. The globalists win. And that's why you can't be manipulated by it. You've got to stay calm. You've got to maintain your emotional control. Don't pull out the guns just because you have them. We've got to de-escalate this situation. In every case here on the Alex Jones Show, you've heard Alex and others call for non-violence, for peaceful resolution and restoration of law and restoration of the Bill of Rights and restoration of basic human dignity. That's what we need in America today, not more race wars. Stay with us. We're going to cover more news right here straight ahead. This is Mike Adams on the Alex Jones Show. We'll be right back.
Right now, the average family spends 1/4 of their income on food. It's time to cut your food budget in half by using the best, most affordable food on the planet from eFoods Direct. The savings from eating this food will actually help you pay your other bills. Serve these delicious meals to your family tonight for a quick and easy dinner for about $1.25 a serving, compared to over $3 a serving for any other food. This food is compact, making it easy to store some away, and will be just as delicious in 25 years as the ones you cook tonight. Is it affordable? Absolutely. The new Alex Jones Family Pack saves you up to 50% compared to other food storage companies. See the comparison at eFoodsDirect.com/Alex or call 800-409-5633. My friends, as crazy as this world is today, you'd be nuts to not get a storable food supply. Give eFoods Direct a call and order one of the Alex Jones Family Packs and test it out today. Start your journey of food independence today at eFoodsDirect.com/Alex or call 800-409-5633.
BeatPrepared.com is making deals in April because you need to be prepared now and you need to save. BeatPrepared.com is the official site of Emergency Essentials, a 24-year leader in emergency preparedness supplies. Everything from long-term food storage to emergency kits, water storage and filtration to alternative light and heat sources. What's on sale? Now through April 30th, save 28% on a freeze-dried garden vegetable combo, which includes peas, corn, beans, cauliflower, celery, and onions. Save 33% on the Katadyn Hiker Micro filter. New instant white rice as low as $8.49 and a 72-hour MRE food and water supply, a $72 value for only $49.99 and much more at BeatPrepared.com. Call 800-999-1863 to experience exceptional customer service and our low price guarantee. That's 800-999-1863. Hurry, the BeatPrepared.com April sale ends April 30th. The choice is clear. Be unprepared or BeatPrepared.com.
We all know that Berkey Water Purification Systems are the most trusted name in water filtration. As an authorized Berkey dealer for over 6 years and serving thousands of satisfied customers, the Berkey Guy offers amazing specials for Berkey Water Filtration Systems. The Berkey Light Systems include a set of self-sterilizing and recleanable black purification elements that purify water by removing chlorine, pathogenic bacteria, cysts, and parasites to non-detectable levels and remove harmful chemicals such as herbicides and pesticides. Order the Berkey Light System today, complete with two black Berkey elements for only $231, and the Berkey Guy will ship your order free of charge. With the purchase of a Berkey Light, the Berkey Guy is also offering a set of fluoride and arsenic filters for only $39.99. That's over 30% off the retail price. Call the Berkey Guy at 1-877-886-3653. That's 1-877-886-3653. Or order online at GoBerkey.com. That's GoBerkey.com today.
HempUSA.org has moved and expanded its operations for faster worldwide shipping. Our product line has grown from 5 to nearly 100 items in less than 5 years. Our food is grown naturally, always chemical-free, not found in stores. Great for daily intake and perfect for your emergency storage shelter. Call 908-691-2608 or visit HempUSA.org and see what our powder, seeds, and oil can do for you.
We the People grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Hi, Ted Anderson. I'm placing a silver dollar in a book explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Yeah, we're back. Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show on Tuesday, April 10th, 2012. We are fired up here at the InfoWars Studios in Austin, Texas. And guess what? We're joined right now via phone by Alex Jones himself. Alex, are you on the phone with us?
Yeah, it's coming to you via my cruddy cell phone. You were just so on fire during the last segment. I had to call in because you're absolutely right. But the reason we're going to get from every angle is because we're more aware of it now, and because the enemy knows that we're waking up and is desperate to clamp back down on us. But I just wanted to say this. When you mentioned the article of him taking the woman's baby, I mean, that was in the news. It happens all the time now for not vaccinating. Folks, you have to understand, there is no law. The police are so brainwashed by Child Protective Services that it's just a family planning slash eugenics group set up in the U.S. around 1915. It's outside of the regular courts. That all over the place they're taking children and vaccinating in public schools during the H1N1 3.5 years ago. We were getting reports from parents everywhere in Alabama and Texas and New York, California. They were shooting their kids up. And then it came out that indeed, oh, it's an accident. We shot up hundreds of kids whose parents had said no with the H1N1 on record that made them sick and reduced their immunity and had all these extra viruses in it. I mean, all that's come out. All that's been admitted. So it's a hoax that it's good for you. It's a hoax that it's the law. But if parents don't know what they're doing, or they think you're poor and ignorant, you're black, Hispanic, white, doesn't matter what color you are, Asian, but they think you're poor and ignorant, they call in police. They say, we believe this is a bad parent because they won't vaccinate, even though there's no law. And the state takes your child, shoots it up with a bunch of stuff. I mean, understand, we're now into 1 in 50, 1 in 60 or so, depending on the actuary, with autism. We are a society collapsing. There's a video report I did up on Infowars.com last night when I was on RT, where I broke down the fact that the Club of Rome, through an MIT report, has come out and said at least 50% of us, in some actuaries it's worse, will be dead within 20-something years because of the total collapse of society. They're engineering it, folks. You've got to realize that this is happening, and the system is desperate.
But Alex, there's another element to this, too. Remember, when the state steals your child and vaccinates that child, they have their vaccine courts where you can't take it to a regular court. You can't make a claim,
that's right,
but the damage is on your shoulders as the parents. You have to pay for the vaccine damage.
And they admit it's happening. So what's happening is this hoax is coming down. And so parents start saying no. In fact, many areas, California, more than 70% in the highly educated counties are saying no. So then they pass a law saying, we'll shoot your kid up without telling you. These are criminal, out-of-control tyrants, just like the Soviets and others, and it's real, and it's happening. And in closing, the system is getting desperate to be publicly having NBC get it tapes to make George Zimmerman sound racist, to have the Black Panthers, the new Black Panthers, saying, we're angry there's not a race war. Get it going. The system is desperate to get us fighting with each other because the bankers want to sit offshore and rob us. The enemy is Goldman Sachs and J.P. Morgan and crony capitalism. It's the opposite of free market. They are the enemy. That's the problem. That's who's setting this up. That's who's pushing this whole thing. That's the problem. And so the system knows that this is all coming to a head. And in closing, that Patrick Henningsen article that's at Infowars.com, because he's a real journalist like you over at National News, he has talked to the source inside the prosecutor's office and said the decision has been made not to even try to go to the grand jury and that it's going to be a no bill even if it does, and that the media knows that and is still trying to play it up so when it comes out there's a bunch of violence. That is criminal, and that's what the whole New World Order prostitute media does. When Nightline comes to visit me, or MSNBC, or the Southern Poverty Law Center writes articles, they say we're inciting violence when it's the opposite. This is the hoax and the fraud of these enemies of America, these offshore propaganda arms trying to cause a civil war here in America that's going to get a lot of people of all colors and police and fire department people killed. This is going to be an absolute disaster, and these terrorists are preparing to try to launch a race war in this nation to play us off against each other. This is such a giant magnitude. And Mike Adams, I'm so honored to have you sitting in for me. You do such an amazing job. God bless you. I know you've got some more news coming back from break, and then one of the guests that's been persecuted. But this is real, folks. The government is trying to force inoculations on children and taking them away when there's no law. That's kidnapping. And that shows how brazen these crooks are and how far this tyranny's gone. But they only do it to folks they think are poor and ignorant, showing the premeditated evil of this, ladies and gentlemen. So speak out and expose it. Mike Adams, thank you so much for sitting in today.
Thank you, Alex. No, you're exactly right. You're right. You're 100% on target with that. Look, the system attacks you, Alex, when you call for restoring the Bill of Rights. Somehow they equate that with calling for violence. That's absurd. Yet they allow these race wars to escalate and escalate, leading to shootings and killings that they know are going to play in their favor. They're the ones pushing violence. We're going to keep telling the truth right here on The Alex Jones Show. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
We're on the march. The empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
$4, $5, $6, even $7 a gallon? According to fuel industry insiders and economic experts, those are the forecasted fuel prices, with no end in sight. Fight back fuel prices with a fuel saver from airfusionsystems.com. These fuel savers can save you from 20 to 40%. They're designed to fit any vehicle, from compacts to SUVs to transport trucks. The fuel saver works on all gas, diesel, even propane engines. Easy do-it-yourself installation in about 15 minutes. And the best part? No engine modifications, no computer chipping, no running wires, no chemicals, no water, no running costs, and no maintenance. And these fuel savers come complete with all parts and accessories. See how it works at airfusionsystems.com, spelled A-I-R-F-U-S-I-O-N, systems.com. Or call 888-887-9981, 888-887-9981. Fuel savers from airfusionsystems.com. Save fuel, save money, save Earth.
When you're out on the road, the last place you want to be is on the road. But if the unfortunate happens, you'll be glad you were wearing diamond gussets.
There's a place down in Tennessee where they make blue diamond gusset jeans. They sew pride in every stitch. Guarantee you love the way they fit. They put a diamond gusset in the crotch where you need it most. Blue diamond gusset's got it, others don't.
We turn jeans inside out. Diamond gusset jeans, made in the USA with unparalleled quality. Our Defender motorcycle jeans combine gusset comfort with Kevlar protection, so you can ride all day with confidence. Order yours at gusset.com. Diamond gusset jeans got it, others don't.
A little over a year ago, I began to do a lot of research into why, even though I had a pretty good-sized meal, that I was still starving. And my research led me to a well-known fact that most of the soils that we grow our crops on here in the United States and across the industrialized world are almost completely depleted of almost all of the key minerals and trace elements that our bodies need to rebuild themselves, fight off cancer, and be healthy. I then searched out the best vitamin and mineral company out there and discovered Youngevity. The Youngevity products are designed to give you the real nutrition you need, and once you've got that, you don't have to eat as much to be satisfied. I've lost 37 pounds in 2 months, simply getting the vitamins and minerals I need. Check it out for yourself. It's incredible. Go to InfoWarsTeam.com today and order your first canister of Beyond Tangy Tangerine Complete Multivitamin Mineral Complex Dietary Supplement. That's InfoWarsTeam.com.
It's going to be a fascinating show right here. Thanks for staying with us here on the Alex Jones Show. This is Mike Adams, the Health Ranger, filling in. I'm the editor of naturalnews.com, where today, in fact, we have a special InfoWars edition of news posted there. I hand-selected all that news for today to just really support the InfoWars mission. We've started to use Aaron Dykes' research as a source in our own reporting. Aaron Dykes, Kurt Nimmo, Paul Watson, the amazing InfoWars.com news team are now just, they are generating the just amazing news, for example, about the paralysis being caused by the vaccines in India. Even though India has been free of polio, now the nation is suffering from widespread paralysis caused by the vaccines themselves. That was a story by Aaron Dykes, and we have cited Aaron Dykes as a source on that. So there's a lot of cross-pollination going on between InfoWars and Natural News as we all try to cover this and bring you the information that can help restore liberty. Now, in this segment, by the way, we do have James Stewart joining us in just a minute. He is the Rawsome Foods founder, one of the founders, the operator there who was thrown in jail, tortured by LA County. There's a lot more to that story. You probably heard much of his story. He's going to be talking to us today about a lot more, about what his experience being intimidated and being arrested and tortured by the bureaucrats there in LA County and Ventura County, what that means for the nation at large. He's got firsthand experience and is going to lend us some insight into what that means for the future of America. But real quickly, check this out. You know how you collapse the honeybee populations? You feed them corn syrup laced with pesticides. That's the additional news that's come out. And in fact, in order to remember, I was talking about these pesticides, these neonicotinoids is the class of pesticides that has been found yet again to collapse honeybee populations. The way that they simulated that collapse in the lab was to feed the bees corn syrup with that chemical in it. There you go. Check out more stories about that on Infowars.com, by the way. I know they're posting stories right now as we speak. I want to bring in James Stewart with a quick background. Just so you know, James Stewart is the Rawsome Foods guy. He's been called the California milkman by the judge that reduced his bail from the $1 million level down to $100,000. He spent 8 days lost in the LA County jail system. They sort of lost him in the system. They flooded his jail cell with raw sewage. They subjected him to hypothermia, to denial of food, basic starvation, to involuntary medical procedures and tests, had him shackled in chains. And what is his crime? He was distributing food to infants and children. And many mothers there in California were using Rawsome as a distribution point for the raw goat's milk that they were feeding their babies because they couldn't breastfeed. So we're talking about basic nutrition for humanity. We're talking about basic human rights. And they destroyed James's food distribution point, and he now faces many years potentially in prison. The case is still pending against him. He joins us by phone. Thank you, James Stewart, for having the courage to speak out and join us once again here on The Alex Jones Show. Are you with us?
Good morning, Mike. Yes, I am.
Good morning, James. I hope you're fired up, man, because I don't know about you, but I'm sick of the oppression. I'm sick of the way they treat farmers and people like you who are providing real food to real mothers and real infants in America. I've just had it, and I want to be an optimist long term, but in the short term, it just feels like we're all under attack. What are your thoughts on what's happening in America today based on what has happened to you personally?
Well, the first thing I want to say is, since when did being involved with food and on top of that high quality food become an act of terrorism? I mean, really, that's really the question. We asked for a long time when we were initially under attack from different sources, you know, who's authorizing it and for what purpose? And of course, we still don't have a real answer, although, as you know, many people who, and maybe there might be some new people on here as well. A couple of years ago in Massachusetts, there was another food club that was closed, and basically the FDA, who was sued, had to answer their questions because they were sued. And the bottom line of that was that you and I and the public have no right to decide and what we're going to put into our own bodies or our children's bodies. That the FDA has the ultimate authority.
I remember that statement by the FDA. Shocking that we don't even own our own bodies. In essence, in fact, remember the FDA has gone after women who are pumping breast milk to sell it to other women who can't breastfeed, so they're helping to save a child. They're being intimidated by the FDA. The FDA basically says you don't even own your own body fluids.
It's insane. And, you know, we see it every day. It's not just with Rawsome or, you know, Farm to Fork or, you know, Hershberger or all the other people out there. They're doing it now with pig farmers and the state of Michigan. And, I mean, it's everywhere. And so at this point, it's hard to understand why people can't actually see that their actual freedom of choice is being removed.
Well, I think part of that, let's remember that the mainstream media hasn't really even covered your story. I mean, did the Washington Post, did even the LA Times, they didn't report how you were tortured in the LA County jail. They didn't report that at all. So I think the mainstream person out there who's watching CNN or Fox News or whatever, especially since they canceled the best show on there, Judge Napolitano, it's watered down now, and the people don't see what's really happening. So it's like, how can we even expect the mainstream people out there to have an understanding of the reality of what's going on?
I completely agree. The mainstream media is, I don't think they're asleep. I think they're part of the problem, as you and I both know. So, you know, at this point, by the way, Rawsome is gone, and the property has now been returned to vacant land, so all of the so-called illegal structures and the community has now been completely wiped out.
No, James, I got it. You know what? You know what your problem is, James? You're not black enough. If you were black and you were running Rawsome Foods and they came after you with guns, the entire African-American community would be up in arms over it. You're too white. That's the problem, James. You're too white, so the media won't cover it. You got that?
Yeah, well, you know, Mike, I hate to bring, and I just refuse to bring race into anything because, you know, Rawsome was a community in which was open to everybody, and it didn't matter who you were, what you ate, or anything else, and that's the way I still want it. And, you know, I don't know if what you said is true. It probably is a little bit, but I'd rather not, you know, bring up that subject because I'd rather be inclusive rather than exclusive.
Well, no, you're exactly right. I was not trying to be exclude anyone. What my point was that the media is very selective in reporting who is being oppressed. So a white guy like you selling raw milk gets no media attention. But if an African American had been running that operations and sheriffs came in and put them in handcuffs like they did you and tortured you in the jail and put guns or brought guns to the scene, then that would have been made into a much bigger issue. Let's be honest about it.
I probably can't disagree with you, Mike. And, you know, that's one of the other, you know, divisions that are going on out there. They want, you know, people to be divided so they can't form a beautiful alliance with each other. And I appeal to everybody, especially in this the industry that we're in, the health, alternative health industry, whatever you want to call it. I appeal to people not to fight each other, but to join forces with each other. Even if you respectfully disagree with the person that you're in, you know, that you are in competition with. You know, that's the main reason why corporations are basically probably behind all of this, is because they're trying to eliminate the competition. And you and I both know that sales of pasteurized dairy products, pharmaceuticals, and whatnot are in the decline.
Yes.
And why they're in the decline is people have decided to take charge of their own health.
I agree with you completely, James. And in fact, you know, I wrote a story last week about freedom is based on tolerance, that we have to de-escalate violence, that we have to be inclusive of other people's views and other people's behaviors, other people's choices, even if we don't agree with them. So I know you and I are on the same page with that. I'm a little bit angry at the complete unfair treatment of a person like you, being who was so oppressed, who was so mistreated, who's now even now facing decades in prison potentially, and a total media blackout on it, because I guess what your story doesn't fit their agenda.
I get it, Mike. You know, and I myself, you know, I'm appreciative of you in that article, by the way, in which we have to have tolerance of others, you know, otherwise we don't have freedom at all. And that was a very well-written article, my friend, and I really appreciate it.
Well, let me take a deep breath here, man, because ultimately, I know you and I are both optimists. I know you and I both believe in restoring freedom, restoring the republic. Let's talk about that for a second. You and I were on the phone just the other day talking about the difference between a democracy and a republic. There's a film out there on YouTube that explains that. I think it's only a 10-minute film. It's very important. James, what are your thoughts on why we need a republic and the restoration of law to put these tyrants in check so they can't just run rampant over everybody?
Well, first of all, real law. I mean, a republic is based on the rule of law. And, you know, that's what most people don't know. But they're actually now, the other force out there, they're actually trying to make people like myself and you and Alex Jones and other people look like anarchists when we're actually just the opposite. We're totally into the, you know, government and the right form of government that's controlled by laws, of course. But when they get out of hand with which they're done now, this is not, you know, we've become again what many other countries around the world for thousands of years have become, and that's an oligarchy and whatnot, where a group of people are controlling it, and it's not a republic. People are not protected any longer. And a republic, if you actually go online and you just type into YouTube democracy versus republic, the first video on there is amazing. It's so well done, you know, that it informs us about how it all really works and what's going on in the idea of government. And I urge people to educate themselves. But, you know, right now, I think that people need to stand up. I think people are in fear, Mike, and I'm hoping that they'll get over their fears because, you know, they're only creating their own demise by not putting anything into action. And I don't mean that, you know, meanly or whatnot to people, but, you know, that's the reason why. You know, Ben Franklin said, you know, I gave you a republic if you can keep it. Now, why did he use the word if? Well, maybe he was suspect even from the beginning whether people would actually take charge and responsibility for keeping the republic, and as we view now, it's not happening.
Well, he was a student of history. He saw what happens when power always gets corrupt. It always becomes more centralized. Everybody in a position of power or every organization of power, whether it's a government or a union or a city council, every body of power wants to grab more power. It's actually like a nation of cancer tumors. Running around, and cancer tumors work the same way. They try to bring in blood vessels and bring in more nutrients so they can grow and become more powerful. So we're looking at a cancerous government ruling over the people without honoring the rule of law that's set out in the Bill of Rights in the Republic.
Yeah, well, you know, when they start calling people like myself terrorists, and I never use the word myself, but sovereigns, and, you know, any time that they can grab a hold of a term or a word and use it against us because one person out there who claimed he was decided to do something in violence, which I never advocate at all, then they can use that word. So, you know, we have to be careful as a mass of people not to actually do things. I don't believe in violence. I believe in nonviolence. So, you know, I believe that all we have to do is take back the power that we've so unwillingly allowed to not, you know, that we don't want to take responsibility, you know.
I completely agree with you.
All Rawsome was a community of people, like-minded to compute, a community of people that wanted to take the opportunity to obtain things that they couldn't find anywhere else. Now, why is that? And by the way, your comment about Judge Napolitano's show, Freedom Watch, being taken off is really suspect. You and I both know that. He did an excellent job, and I hope that he's back on someplace else.
Yeah, well, he was clearly getting very close to the target, right? Because that kind of the power in his voice and the issues that he was willing to cover is probably what got him kicked off the air. But I want to get back to the sovereign citizen issue, because when LA County took you into custody there and threw you in jail there, they then took you into a little room and had a mini interrogation of you, as I recall you relating to me. And then they accused you of claiming that you were a sovereign citizen and then put an armband on you, which of course echoes right back to Nazi Germany and the way those prisoners were treated there before they were hauled off to the gas chambers. And then you were subjected to extra torture, extra chains and shackles around your waist because you had this armband. Is that not correct, James?
Boy, it is exactly correct, and I never mentioned the word at all, but no, that's what they did, and so they put a red armband, which meant I was a danger to the community. We're not talking about the community outside the jail. We're talking about they were saying that I was a danger to the community inside the jail.
Right, like you, the milkman, are more dangerous than the murderers and rapists that were also in there? Really?
Yep.
The gangbangers?
Yep.
Unbelievable.
Yeah, it was. You know, I just find it ludicrous, but, you know, that it just shows you. I'm sharing these things with people so they understand that this is now happening to people out there. You know, I'm a perfect example. So, you know, I share those things without any, you know, try to not exaggerate at all. Yeah, they shackled me and chained me to a bench for like 6 hours in the medical pod. In the beginning, there was a nice sheriff or whatnot inside there that I appealed to, who not only was I shackled, you know, around my waist and whatnot, but then additionally in my hands behind my back for hours, but they also handcuffed me to the bench, which meant I couldn't move more than 6 inches in either direction for hours. You try that for a while, and, you know, without actually having to physically touch you and torture you, it's pretty torturous. But this one guy came over, and he was a little confused as to why I would be, you know, shackled doubly. So he actually undid the handcuffs, so at least I could move on the bench a little bit.
Well, a little bit of mercy for you there by one of the prison guards. I've been interviewing small farmers around Texas, by the way. That hasn't come out yet, so I don't want to give away that whole story. But people cited your story, James, as a reason that they were afraid to start selling raw dairy. Now, I'm announcing this for the first time on national radio. I own dairy goats now. In fact, I milked goats before I came into the show this morning. We've got Nigerian dwarf goats that have super sweet milk, and we milk them twice a day, and they're just amazing little creatures, just a joy to be around, and I'm getting actual milk nutrition. I'm actually starting to drink raw milk again because I haven't consumed milk for a long time, a decade or more, and I can't, when I'm milking these goats and I'm seeing this milk come out, I can't imagine that this is a criminal substance if I go barter it with my neighbor. I can't imagine that I could be thrown in jail for this substance. And then I talk to these other farmers around Texas and they say they're afraid to sell it. They don't want to get involved because they don't want to go to jail. So there is a suppression effect happening because of what they did to you. Do you think, James, that's part of the reason why they're trying to make such a big deal out of your case?
I absolutely do. I think they want to make examples of people so they will force people into not wanting to move into a direction that their actual creativity is saying, right. I'd like to do.
Stay with us, James. We got to take a quick break here. We'll be right back on the Alex Jones Show with more on food freedom with James Stewart. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
Tell you that humanity is in a deep crisis. Everyone can feel it. We know a tectonic struggle is now taking place between the forces of freedom and those who love darkness, bondage, and enslavement. Yes, my friends, evil is rising. But take heart, for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. Recently, New World Order operative Hillary Clinton admitted they're losing the info war.
We are in an information war, and we are losing that war.
The globalists are scared. They've overreached. The future of the info war is in your hands. Join PrisonPlanet.tv. Download the thousands of special video reports, ebooks, and more, and get them out to everyone you know. Continue to spread the word about the broadcast on YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, and every other globalist propaganda platform. We are going to use their system against them. The info war now goes into high gear.
We all know the importance of having storable foods, but what about when the food runs out? What then? For real food independence, you need a supply of non-hybrid seeds. Introducing the Survival Seed Vault from MyPatriotSupply.com. The Survival Seed Vault is sealed for freshness and includes 20 varieties of easy-to-grow non-hybrid seeds for only $37.95. For less than $40, you've got real food independence. And the Survival Seed Vault includes detailed planting and seed-saving instructions. Imagine the barter power you'll have when the food supply does collapse. Right now, save $9 instantly when you buy three or more Survival Seed Vaults from MyPatriotSupply.com. Same-day shipping on all orders, plus free shipping on orders over $49. Call 866-229-0927. That's 866-229-0927. Or discover more emergency preparedness products at MyPatriotSupply.com. That's MyPatriotSupply.com.
Hi, I'm Mark Craighead, founder of Crossbreed Holsters. I designed our top-selling holster, the Super Tuck Deluxe, to solve the problems of being poked, pinched, and gouged while carrying concealed. The Super Tuck Deluxe is the most comfortable, most concealable holster on the market today. We offer a 2-week free trial and a lifetime warranty.
Visit us at crossbreedholsters.com. Don't forget, crossbreedholsters.com.
In a coming-apart world, you need something to keep it tied together. That something is Atwood Rope, the highest quality rope made in the USA from exotic braids for military, rescue, arborists, shipyards, towline, or boating. Quality rope at affordable prices you and your customers can depend on. Find a dealer or shop online at atwoodrope.net. Enter promo code RADIO to receive 100 feet of 550 paracord free with purchase. Atwood Rope, working to keep the world tied together.
Yeah, welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. This is Mike Adams, the Health Ranger, filling in for Alex today, who actually called in and joined us for a few minutes in the last segment. We're talking with James Stewart, the founder of Rawsome Foods. Rawsome is now completely disassembled it is gone. So Ventura County has succeeded temporarily in their mission to destroy a food distribution center and deny parents the right to acquire milk that they already own, because they own a portion of the farm, a portion of the cow, a portion of the goat, and so on. I want to mention a note here as James joins us about authenticity. Authenticity is crucial when you decide where to get your information, who to believe, who to listen to. And these people in Washington, these people at the state capitals, and these people, these bureaucrats who live in these shining cities like out of Hunger Games, and they live in their offices all day long, and they never get out in the real world. They don't know what real food is, okay? Right now, you are listening to James Stewart and myself, who are two people who are intimately and authentically involved in raising our own food. I really do milk my goats. I really milked them this morning before I came here. I don't just say that, okay? I'll send pictures, or I'm going to shoot a video, actually, to show you what terrorists these little goats are, according to the FDA. But we don't just say these things. We are involved in raising our own food as much as we can. It is authentic. We know what we're talking about. James, what do you think about those people who sit in their palaces and comment on you and talk about how you should be criminalized, even though it's people like you who are producing the food that keeps them alive?
Well, this is very true. And by the way, I want to correct something. It is the county of Los Angeles that originally and most completely is the one that eliminated Rawsome.
Okay, my bad. Sorry, L.A.
Ventura is part of it in a whole nother way, which is also insanity. Their contention that I was involved in ripping off people is just insane. Everybody knows who I am on that level. But, you know, again, what was the question, Mike?
Well, just what you think about authentic food and how it's the farmers across America who are feeding the tyrants who are oppressing their liberties.
It is pretty insane, isn't it? I mean, you know, the people who actually, the blood, sweat, and the tears come from the people who are actually involved with their hands and doing something. You know, quite a few times people complain, they contended that they actually helped start Rawsome. I won't mention names and whatnot, where they never put a finger into it. So to me, it reminds me of the same thing that whoever you want to call them, the bureaucracy, the other side, whatever, I don't even understand. And by the way, I have a really interesting piece of news for you that happened when I was dismantling Rawsome over the last 3 or 4 days. And that was this. I was at the last stage of removing some of the shipping containers on the lot, and a black and white unit showed up, and I won't tell from what city, and I thought they were coming for me again.
The police.
Instead, they went next door to the coffee shop, and I happened to be standing on the sidewalk about 10 minutes later, and the two officers came out. One of them walked up to me and said, "Are you James Stewart?" He said, "Aren't you James Stewart?" And I said, "Yes." And I was thinking, now what? And he said, "You probably don't know me because I never came into your place dressed in uniform, but I was one of your members."
Right.
And he said, "What I think has happened here is a travesty." Now, I'm not going to mention his name or what city he works for or whatnot, but that just shows you that there are people, actually, there were many people inside government that actually were members of Rawsome. There were, you know, attorneys and medical doctors and you name it. The list was long.
Hey, James, we're out of time, believe it or not. Sorry to interrupt, but I got to thank you for being here today.
All right.
Is there a website real quick that where people can stay informed about Rawsome?
You know, more through you than anybody else, Mike.
All right, we'll keep publishing the stories then, man. Naturalnews.com and Infowars.com. A lot gets posted there as well. Stay with us. We'll be right back with Patrick Henningsen ahead on the next hour and a lot more breaking news on The Alex Jones Show.
This is GCN, the Genesis Communications Radio Network.
This is Alex Jones with 5 good reasons you should consider buying a solar power generator. Number 1, new climate legislation could easily double or triple your electric bill. Number 2, our new energy czar wants to control how much power your electric company allows you to have. It's true. Total government control of electricity in the name of smart grid technology is coming. Number 3, in some areas of the country, the power grid is dangerously overloaded. And now, new socialist legislation is only compounding the problem. Number 4, dangerous weather is always a threat to local grids. Every year, thousands of families lose their power from weather-related outages. Number 5, A solar power generator provides powerful backup, insurance, and peace of mind. Folks, I really believe in the solar power generators offered by Solutions from Science, one of my oldest sponsors. You can get more information at www.mysolarbackup.com. That's mysolarbackup.com. Remember, the government doesn't own the sun, so go to mysolarbackup.com or call 1-877-327-0365.
Waging war on corruption. Alex Jones on the GCM Radio Network.
Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
We are into the second hour on the Alex Jones Show. This is Mike Adams, the Health Ranger, the editor of Natural News. Filling in for Alex today, we just completed an interview with James Stewart, founder of Rawsome Foods, about food freedom and much more. I'm going to give you some more breaking news right now, well, or comments on some of the news that's out there. The Red Cross calls for drug decriminalization. This is part of the ongoing wave, the momentum of international and national calls for decriminalizing medical marijuana in particular, and also just small quantities of recreational marijuana. Regardless of what you think about marijuana, and by the way, on the record, I am not a recreational drug user and have never been. That's right, never. I don't even drink alcohol, but that's just my choice. What's clear from this war on drugs is that it really just benefits the prison system. It benefits the police. It benefits that whole system that keeps people suppressed. It does not, in fact, treat drug users for their health, their medical condition, which is an addiction. So if we want to overcome this drug abuse, which is widespread across America, then, of course, we've got to start treating this like a health and medical condition, and not just a criminal situation. Now, speaking of drug addiction, here's another story. The USDEA has now extended its crackdown on prescription painkillers to Walgreens pharmacies. Yes, the DEA raided a Walgreens store in Jupiter, Florida, and it found that literally two-thirds of all the painkillers that were prescribed in that zip code were prescribed by this one pharmacy. Gee, you think someone's overdoing the prescriptions there a little bit? You bet they are. The truth is, more people are addicted to prescription drugs than recreational drugs. Certainly a lot more than marijuana. And the truth is, a lot of the prescription drugs are just different patented synthetic variations of what used to be street drugs. And another truth is that the psychiatric drugging of soldiers, which is causing just massive problems. And guys, could you bring up that infographic, by the way, on the psych drugging of soldiers? We created that. It's very informative. But that is just another way for Big Pharma to make more money by using human bodies as a profit-generating mechanism. So for those of you on the radio, you can't see this, but on prisonplanet.tv, you can see this infographic we created over at Natural News. This is the psych drugging of U.S. soldiers, and it breaks it down with the statistics. We have over 100,000 active duty soldiers on mind-altering drugs right now. The side effects are suicide, accidents, violence, and drug addiction. 300% increase in illegal drug use also in the U.S. military over a three-year period beginning or ending in 2008. We've got a third of the U.S. Army is now on drugs. We're talking people in the field. When they send them out into the field, they give them a 180-day supply of mind-altering psychiatric drugs to take into the field with them. You think the soldiers don't barter that and trade that back and forth? Of course they do. They're all into that, and it's being pushed on them, even when the soldiers don't want it. They may go to the VA hospital and say, I want to be treated like a human being. I want to be treated with dignity. I help protect the freedoms of this country. Give me some medical assistance. And you know what they say? Shut up and take these pills. Shut up and take the Xanax or these painkillers or these psychotropic mind-altering drugs. Go home and stop complaining. And then they go home, and occasionally one of them gets violent and shoots somebody or kills themselves or causes a problem. And then they blame the soldiers. They blame the soldiers. And the press doesn't even blame the pharmaceutical industry. But again, kudos to the LA Times for pointing out the widespread use of those drugs by the military today. In Houston, it's illegal to feed the homeless now. How's that for compassion? You can't even feed the homeless people if you want to. Oh, man. We've got a lot more coming up. Patrick Henningsen will be joining us in this upcoming segment to talk about the escalation of the race wars in America. We'll try to, in the next hour, we'll try to control ourselves here. We do have good news coming, a lot of optimism and justification for it. I'll share that with you as we continue. Stay with us right here on The Alex Jones Show. We'll be right back.
Hi, folks. This is Alex Jones. I'm looking for people that have the wisdom to spot savings, opportunity, and recognize risk. Saving means to make money. The Cowbin Pure Soap Company can save you thousands of dollars and give you good old-fashioned real soaps that are triple concentrated and twice as good as what you're using now. Soaps made from vegetable and coconut oils that contain no useless dyes, perfumes, deodorants, or antibacterials. Your risk is the hundreds of hazardous toxic detergents that give you rashes, itching sores, and deteriorating clothing called lint. If you want something better, if you want something you've never had before, you have to do something you've never done before. Getting a free catalog is easy by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calvin on the web at 5starsoap.com. Take charge of your health now by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calvin on the web at 5starsoap.com. Right now, the average family spends one-fourth of their income on food. It's time to cut your food budget in half by using the best, most affordable food on the planet from eFoods Direct. The savings from eating this food will actually help you pay your other bills. Serve these delicious meals to your family tonight for a quick and easy dinner for about $1.25 a serving, compared to over $3 a serving for any other food. This food is compact, making it easy to store some away, and will be just as delicious in 25 years as the ones you cook tonight. Is it affordable? Absolutely. The new Alex Jones Family Pack saves you up to 50% compared to other food storage companies. See the comparison at eFoodsDirect.com/Alex or call 800-409-5633. My friends, as crazy as this world is today, you'd be nuts to not get a storable food supply. Give eFoods Direct a call and order one of the Alex Jones Family Packs and test it out today. Start your journey of food independence today at eFoodsDirect.com/Alex or call 800-409-5633.
Hi, folks. This is Alex Jones. I'm looking for people that have the wisdom to spot savings, opportunity, and recognize risk. Saving means to make money. The Cowbin Pure Soap Company can save you thousands of dollars and give you good old-fashioned real soaps that are triple concentrated and twice as good as what you're using now. Soaps made from vegetable and coconut oils that contain no useless dyes, perfumes, deodorants, or antibacterials. Your risk is the hundreds of hazardous toxic detergents that give you rashes, itching sores, and deteriorating clothing called lint. If you want something better, if you want something you've never had before, you have to do something you've never done before. Getting a free catalog is easy by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calvin on the web at 5starsoap.com. Take charge of your health now by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calvin on the web at 5starsoap.com.
Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
This is the Alex Jones Show. Mike Adams, Health Ranger, filling in for you today. I want to thank Alex for the invite to fill in. And I want to thank you, the listeners, for allowing me to continue to fill in for Alex from time to time when he invites me. I really appreciate all your positive comments out there. I hope I'm doing a good job for you working here on the front lines of liberty, trying to bring the issues to the forefront that matter for our collective future. And I want to take calls from you today. So let me give out the number here. That is 800-259-9231. And those are going to be calls from anyone. So open lines. Please call in if you have a comment, a question. You'd like to talk about anything that we are covering today. The overriding theme today is America under assault by chemicals, and our farms and food freedoms are under assault by our government. You can talk about Obama's executive order from March 16th, the government seizure of farms and food and seeds and all that. You can talk about anything you want. Ask me a question if you want, but just remember, I'm not a doctor, so I can't give you specific health advice. Now, let's get to some of the other news that has been breaking recently. Alex reported on this yesterday and just yesterday, I think he focused on this. MIT predicts half of humanity could be culled in a post-industrial crash. Alex misspoke and cited that as a 90% reduction. It's actually about a 50% reduction. He called me to ask me to clarify that with all of you today. The chart is right here. This is an article by Aaron Dykes on Infowars.com, and it is true that the MIT scientists have conducted a study in which they predict a global collapse of the population right here, beginning here, this dotted line, at 2030, following a global economic collapse. All right, so we've got other lines that they say represent global pollution, industrial output per capita, food per capita. Notice that the food decline precedes the population decline. So first, right here, the food collapses. That's this dotted line right there, for those of you watching on prisonplanet.tv. And then the population collapse soon follows. Well, why would we have a food collapse? The MIT scientists have their own theories about that. But of course, you, as InfoWars listeners, you probably know even more about why the food supply might collapse. And those reasons include the genetic pollution of our agricultural system, the unleashing of GMOs, the rise of resistant superweeds that take over farms. Now, the destruction of local farming and food production centers all across America by tyrannical, out-of-control, maniac governments. You know, food diversity, it's funny, in America they talk about strategic oil reserves and the diversity of being able to produce oil in Alaska, produce oil in the Gulf, produce oil in Texas, importing a lot of our oil, but being able to have national security by producing oil domestically, right? That makes sense to everybody. Well, what about producing food domestically and not just in the hands of the corporate food producers? Food that is produced in your local town, in your neighborhood or nearby, where you can drive out to a farmer's market and actually buy some basic food, such as raw, fresh milk from a local farmer. All of that is under attack. So that is a national strategic resource that the country, that the government doesn't seem to care about. It's funny, isn't it? You know, the government is into storing ammunition, storing guns. The government stores food and medicine and communications gear, but then they're destroying the food production and going against guns and ammunition for the people. So you see how that works? It's a total contradiction. What's good for the government to survive hard times makes you a potential terrorist if you dare do the same thing. So just another contradiction out there. But it's true, the MIT study is talking about a global collapse. Now we've got some callers on the line. Let's see who's on the line. And thank you for calling, John in California. You're on the air with the Health Ranger. Go ahead, please.
Hey, Mike Adams, long-time listener, first-time caller. Reason why I'm calling is to discuss Fukushima real quick. I got many things to bring out on it. One, my girlfriend was there recently about 2 weeks ago, came back with some illness, nosebleeds. She's reported she's never had nosebleeds her whole life. So then I gave her some kombucha tea. That seemed to kind of have an effective result. Past that, I saw Stephen L. Manley's piece that you guys have probably seen. It's on ENA News about a 500% increase in radioactivity, iodine-131 in the right. Kelp beds throughout all of California. He took samples from Santa Cruz, Pacific Grove, Corona del Mar, just up the coast from here, was showing the highest readings. Then I thought, well, who else has seen this? I contacted surf shops down here. They hadn't heard the news, so I printed it out and gave it down to them. Then I thought, I'm going to contact local government. I called the mayor's office in Newport Beach, and they never got back to me. I called the city government here in Laguna Beach. I talked to Verna Rollinger, who's a city councilwoman, and I talked to the mayor as well. They hadn't seen the article, so they were appreciative on that. However, Verna Rollinger said that she was going to actually print out that piece off of ENE News and then hand it in a discussion at a meeting that she was going to meet with Senator Dianne Feinstein about the San Onofre plant that's maybe shut, maybe still open. So,
well, what you're getting at here, what you're describing, is this massive media cover-up. And you're right. When the radiation is falling onto North America and hitting California and hitting the coast, there's a total blackout on that information. They even change the meters themselves. And then they change the EPA regulations. Are when you bring this information to people, John, are they paying attention to it then? Are they taking action on it?
I don't know. I'm still kind of waiting to hear back, and I feel like there's a slow wheel turning on that. So what I decided to do was go and this weekend, because I talked to them on Friday, just a few days ago. So then I started doing research into this whole matter, going, look, free choice. We have free choice. If nothing else is going to be done about this mess, you know, whatever. The government, everyone else is, like, focused on other things, their own distractions. I don't need to be distracted. I know what's happening. You know what's happening. Your listeners knows what's happening. So we're getting dosed. So let's take action. The one thing I want to talk about is health. The Belrad Institute out of the, Belarus, Ukraine, or Kiev, has done incredible studies with this product called Vitapect. And it's basically a form of pectin with additional natural supplements of vitamins and minerals, to where they've shown in studies where it actually pulls cesium-137 out of the organs of the children.
There are a lot of supplements that work in that way. We've seen spirulina, we've seen chlorella, we've seen sea algae used historically, even in post-World War II Japan. We've seen that in use in Russia following Chernobyl accident. There are a lot of supplements that can actually pull radiation out of your body. But of course, once the radiation damage has happened, especially to your thyroid, then that's permanent damage. Hence the use of potassium iodide to specifically pre-fill up your thyroid with that mineral so that more radiation isn't attracted to it. I want to thank you, John, for your call and bringing up those very, very important points and some possible solutions for people to check out. Very good information. Thank you for your call and your energy. CJ in Michigan, you are on the air. Go ahead, please. What's your question or comment?
Hey, Mike. This is CJ from Michigan. And just want to inform everybody, I've done some research here. We know we're battling the police state here about food freedom. I have a garden in my front yard. I had it for 3 years, no problems. Last year, got a goat. Neighbors went ballistic. Anyway, so I did some research. I'm getting beehives, and the bee guy told me, hey, don't worry. There's something called Michigan Right to Farm Act. Okay.
Really?
So I looked this up. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Look this up. Michigan Right to Farm Act. I'm a little nervous here. Hold on.
No, go ahead. You're doing fine. Go ahead.
Okay. So as long as you're practicing the GAAMP, which stands for the Generally Accepted Agricultural Management Practices, that's a publication every year by the Michigan State University. As long as you're following that, you're protected by this act. And this act protects everything that has to do with the farm. That's sounds, noises, everything. And it supersedes any zoning law. This is the beauty of this law.
That's fascinating. I didn't know Michigan had that. I wonder if other states have that. Let me ask you to comment on this, CJ. The case in Roswell, Georgia that we're reporting on, and by the way, folks, I don't know if that story is posted on Infowars.com yet, but it is the top story right now on naturalnews.com. It involves Andrew Wordies, the backyard chicken farmer. The lawsuit filed against him by the city of Roswell includes this text. They said they declared his property to be a, quote, nuisance property, which they said gave them the right to take it over. And I want your comment on this, CJ. They said a nuisance property, quote, the property is not kept clean and sanitary and free from all accumulations of offensive matter, including dead organic matter. Well, that's just compost, people, kitchen compost, continuing rubbish, junk, animal intestinal waste, and urine. Well, come on, I urinate on my own farm. Does that make it a nuisance? Animal intestinal waste, doesn't that just mean animal droppings? I mean, come on, that's no big deal.
Mike, do a study on this law. It protects all that as long as you're following, those practices. You're doing certain things. And then this act is so beautiful. It was written very broad and inclusive. There's no size limitation. It was intentionally written like this to protect everyone. Now, you have to be a farm. What is a farm? It's someone who actually sells something. So all you got to do is put a little sign out front, eggs for sale. You become a farm.
Well, CJ, but remember, you're citing law. You're citing state law, just as we could cite the Bill of Rights and the Constitution, but now these tyrants that exist today, they say those laws don't matter. We're going to do whatever we want because we can, because we have the guns, because we're the government tyrants. They just nullify all your laws, ignore it, and go ahead and seize your ranch and farm and make you look like a criminal anyway. What do you say about that, CJ?
Exactly. But you know what? And everyone says, oh, forget about it. You know what? I'm going to fight. I'm going to fight for my rights, because if you don't, you lose your rights.
Absolutely.
And the thing is about this law is it has in the act, if someone calls on you three times and the inspector comes out and sees you're following the guidelines, after that, then they become charged. So.
Wow. Okay.
We're
almost out of time, CJ. Sorry to cut you off there. You sound like a really awesome guy. Thanks for bringing up that point. That's what we need, is state right to farm laws, state to state across the whole country. A lot more straight ahead here on the Alex Jones Show. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
I'd seen the longevity products work for many others, and so I bought a bunch of them, started using them, had a little bit of results, but I wasn't following the regimen every day. But Aaron Dykes in my office did and lost more than 60 pounds. When I saw those results, I said, I better follow my own advice. I started taking the longevity products, and it's been incredible. 37 pounds in 2 months. Our bodies are amazing, and God gave us an incredible gift. But if our body doesn't have the tools it needs, all of the vitamins, all of the minerals, and the other key essential trace elements, we're not going to be healthy. Folks, this isn't hype. I only bring to my listeners products that I've tried myself and I truly believe in. And the amazing supplements available at InfoWarsTeam.com have certainly delivered my life. I hope you'll give them a try. Go to InfoWarsTeam.com today and order your first canister of Beyond Tangy Tangerine Complete Multivitamin Mineral Complex Dietary Supplement. That's InfoWarsTeam.com.
We all know the importance of having storable foods, but what about when the food runs out? What then? For real food independence, you need a supply of non-hybrid seeds. Introducing the Survival Seed Vault from MyPatriotSupply.com. The Survival Seed Vault is sealed for freshness and includes 20 varieties of easy-to-grow non-hybrid seeds for only $37.95. For less than $40, you've got real food independence. And the Survival Seed Vault includes detailed planting and seed-saving instructions. Imagine the barter power you'll have when the food supply does collapse. Right now, save $9 instantly when you buy 3 or more Survival Seed Vaults from MyPatriotSupply.com. Same-day shipping on all orders, plus free shipping on orders over $49. Call 866-229-0927. That's 866-229-0927. Or discover more emergency preparedness products at MyPatriotSupply.com. That's MyPatriotSupply.com.
Would it save you time to get the best quality water filters and the best quality storable foods from one company? You bet it would, and now you can at BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com. Big Berkey Water Filter products and great-tasting, long-lasting, storable, wise foods are both now available on one website, BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com. Wise foods, ready-to-eat meals are packed in airtight nitrogen pouches and come with a 25-year shelf life. Big Berkey Water Filters are powerful enough to purify treated, untreated, or even stagnant pond water. Combine Berkey Water Filters with Wise Foods for an unbeatable preparedness combination. Get free shipping on every order over $50. And GCN listeners receive 5% off all ceramic filter systems. Visit BigBerkey waterfilters.com or call 877-99-BERKEY. That's 877-99-BERKEY. Or go to BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com.
Spring is here, growing season. The economy is not getting any better. In fact, it's getting worse. Think about it. At this rate, how will your life be in a month or even a year? Maybe you've been putting things off, but the time to act is now. The country is running out of food. You need to get your seeds before it's too late. At OrganicaSeed.com, you'll find one of the largest online selections of heirloom seeds, survival seed packs, as well as the giant vegetable seed collections that can feed you and your family for years. Grow your very own fresh vegetables, wheatgrass, fruits, herbs, rice, tea, coffee, and tobacco. With detailed growing guides available to you at no charge, you can maximize your harvest and investment. And the best part? All orders ship within 24 hours. So head over to OrganicaSeed.com. That's OrganicaSeed.com. OrganicaSeed.com today.
There is breaking news today about a new microchip technology that can locate you to within centimeters, not just on the XY grid, but vertically as well. So in other words, if you have one of these chips in your cell phones, they will know what floor of an apartment building at which you are residing. This is from, well, this is by Paul Joseph Watson, posted on Infowars.com right now. And it's being linked to by Matt Drudge over at thedrudgereport.com. So I want to thank Matt for that link. The title is New Microchip Knows Your Location to Within Centimeters. Forget a chip in your forehead. The mark of the beast is the cell phone, by Paul Joseph Watson. And the MIT Technology Review reports, quote, Broadcom has just rolled out a chip for smartphones that promises to indicate location ultra precisely, possibly within a few centimeters, vertically and horizontally, indoors and out. It even, they're saying that this will be useful for shopkeepers and retailers to know when you're walking by, so they can then hit you with their personalized advertising messages. Didn't we see what was the movie that this was made famous by with Tom Cruise? Was it a Philip K. Dick Minority Report? That's right. That was in Minority Report. So now, of course, you got to ask, well, how would this retailer know what your preferences are? Well, because you've been surfing the internet and Google cookies have been tracking everything you search for and everything you visit. And therefore, if they share that with brick and mortar retailers, then they can then know your profile the minute you walk by. Wouldn't that be weird? Like, you're on the internet one day searching for storable food and MREs, and then you're walking through the mall with your new microchip cell phone, and all of a sudden a billboard in front of you shows an ad, MREs on sale for long-term preparedness and survival. And you say, whoa, wait a minute, how did they know that? That's the kind of invasion of privacy that we're talking about being made possible by these microchips. Not to mention the ability for local police to locate you and have you arrested for whatever reason they might come up with. And by the way, we are going to have an interview coming up in the third hour with attorney Dale Carson, the author of Arrest Proof Yourself, who gives you tips and strategies for avoiding being arrested, how to handle confrontations with police in a way that keeps your butt out of jail, basically, is what that's all about. You know, don't escalate things, for one thing. But they could use this microchip to find you and come arrest you. So let's say you milk your goat and you have your milk on the internet for sale. I'm going to sell milk to people within the zip code or within the city. They could then use your cell phone chip to come find you, arrest you, throw you in jail, and have you tortured and chained up and shackled as a, quote, sovereign citizen, because you're crazy to think that you should be able to milk your own goats and offer that milk for sale or trade to your neighbors. Pretty amazing, isn't it? Now, coming up, just after this next break, which is still a few minutes away, we're going to have an interview with Mark Baker. He is the Michigan pig farmer whose entire herd was threatened by the Department of Natural Resources bureaucrats in the state of Michigan. They threatened to actually come in and just shoot all the pigs. Just open fire on your livestock, even though they're in your fences, they're in your farm. You've been farming them for 5 or 6 years. Some of these guys out there in Michigan have been farming for 10, 20 years, the same kind of breeds. State just wants to come in and open fire and use your livestock as target practice. Doesn't make any sense, does it? But that's what's happening. So we're going to talk to Mark Baker about that. But before we get to that, I've got a comment about Michigan. What is wrong with Michigan bureaucrats? What is wrong with these people? Remember, this is where Julie Bass was threatened with jail time for growing a garden in Oak Park, Michigan. Remember that town? And in fact, Alex Jones and InfoWars helped publicize that information and get all the charges dropped against Julie Bass. We also had the case of Marianne Godboldo in Detroit. Remember the Detroit mom who refused to medicate her child and she was assaulted by a SWAT team. And guess who spoke out for Marianne Godboldo in addition to her local community? Yeah, a couple of white guys, myself and Alex Jones. Natural News and InfoWars were two of the biggest alternative news sources actually covering that story. So, you know, there's just another example of how we speak out for African Americans when we see injustice. So anybody out there who thinks that InfoWars or Alex is racist, or if they think I'm racist, forget it. We stand up for liberty and justice for people of all races and colors and religions and backgrounds. Just consistently. I can't stand injustice no matter who it's being waged against. And in that case, Marianne Godboldo was being set up and SWAT teamed out of completely irrationally by the state. Now, what else is happening in Michigan? This state just seems to be losing its mind when it comes to farmers. So we're going to talk to Mark Baker about that in more detail and try to get a sense of what's happening in Lansing there and why these bureaucrats are running rampant over the rights of citizens. But it's about more than just food and farms. It's about state bureaucrats could come to your door and your house at any time and take away your children if you don't agree to have them vaccinated or medicated in the way that the state wants you to. All that straight ahead on the Alex Jones Show. Stay with us. This is Mike Adams, the Health Ranger, and we'll be right back after this quick message. Stay with us.
We're on the march. The Empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
A little over a year ago, I began to do a lot of research into why, even though I had a pretty good-sized meal, that I was still starving. And my research led me to a well-known fact that most of the soils that we grow our crops on here in the United States and across the industrialized world are almost completely depleted of almost all of the key minerals and trace elements that our bodies need to rebuild themselves, fight off cancer, and be healthy. I then searched out the best vitamin and mineral company out there and discovered Youngevity. The Youngevity products are designed to give you the real nutrition you need, and once you've got that, you don't have to eat as much to be satisfied. I've lost 37 pounds in 2 months. Simply getting the vitamins and minerals I need. Check it out for yourself. It's incredible. Go to InfoWarsTeam.com today and order your first canister of Beyond Tangy Tangerine Complete Multivitamin Mineral Complex Dietary Supplement. That's InfoWarsTeam.com.
Hi, this is Alex Jones. Did you know that the global elite are now storing non-hybrid seeds in secret storage vaults near the Arctic Circle? Did you know that in a real meltdown, non-hybrid seeds can become more valuable than silver or gold? It's true, seeds have outperformed even gold and silver before in this country, and it's possible that could even happen again. So our friends at Solutions from Science have put together the perfect mix of non-hybrid seeds. They call it a survival seed bank, and it can produce an endless supply of nutrient-dense food for you and your family. And here's the best part. These seeds have not been genetically modified in any way, and you actually get enough seeds to plant a full acre crisis garden. So visit them today at survivalseedbank.com. That's survivalseedbank.com, or give them a call at 877-327-0365. That's 877-327-0365. Remember, in a real crisis, non-hybrid seeds are the ultimate barter item. This is Alex Jones for survivalseedbank.com.
You've heard Alex explain how the Silver Lungs Generator infuses the respiratory system with your self-produced colloidal silver solutions. Yet many are unaware of the entire function of the silver lung system and how it has been designed to deliver your silver solutions anywhere in or on the body. My name is Mario Cifaldi, and I'm the developer of the Silver Lungs Generator. Not only does the silver lung system produce endless colloidal and ionic silver solutions, it also comes equipped with the proper applicators and devices needed to deliver your silver solutions directly to key target areas. This includes the eyes, ears, nose, lungs, topically to the skin, and orally for the digestive system. Be sure to watch our new 7-minute video tour of the Silver Lung System at www.silverlungs.com to learn more about how the Silver Lung System works. As well, we are always ready to answer any questions you may have. That's www.silverlungs.com.
Coming up in just a couple of minutes, we've got Mark Baker from bakersgreenacres.com. He is the Michigan pig farmer whose livestock has been threatened by the state of Michigan. Excuse me. But before that, we've got something fun for you here. You know that we've had this big discussion about SSRIs and psychiatric drugging of soldiers and all of that going on. It's a big deal. And finally, people are waking up to it. Back in 2009, I wrote a song called SSR Lies, and in the spirit of the creativity that goes on here at InfoWars, where Alex does his parodies and the whole crew, they're super talented, a bunch of musicians here, super creative crew, I wanted to play for you about 45 seconds of that song while we're getting our guest online so that you can hear some of what I was talking about back in 2009 that is now becoming more mainstream. So go ahead and cue that song for a little bit.
Coming at the drug wings.
zone.
Check this out.
They think the brightest kids in the nation. I put them on medication and vaccinate them, and they wonder why they can't tolerate them. So they put them on psych meds, and they end up dead. But nobody said they could use health food instead. Messing with your head, can't get out of bed. Eyes are turning red, doctor got no bread. You don't have to follow what the psych doc said. You gotta take your life back, put the knife back down. If it's like that, throw the medication on the ground, cause the medical suckers are gonna psych that. And if you speak in your mind, they're gonna strike that. It's time to learn, you gotta fight back and take your mind back from the medication track.
All right, so some of the words there, you got to take your life back, put the knife back down, throw the medication on the ground, because those medical suckers are going to psych that. And if you're speaking your mind, they're going to strike that. Those are the words of what you just heard there. It might have been a little hard to make out from the song, because I wasn't really using that great of a microphone back in 2009. But you know, that's what we've got to get to in this country. We've got to de-escalate the violence. We've got to de-escalate the race war. We've got to get the drugs out of people's minds, stop the fluoride poisoning of America, stop the GMO poisoning of our crops, stop the electromagnetic poisoning of our brains. We've got to be able to retain the consciousness and the awakening and the basic love for humanity and love for life that's going to give us a future in this world. And that means throwing the medication away. You know, Whitney Houston could probably still be alive today if she wasn't using all those psychiatric drugs or painkillers in her case. Heath Ledger is another Hollywood legend who was killed by an overdose of FDA-approved prescription drugs. It's a very long list. Marilyn Monroe, Elvis Presley, Michael Jackson, their deaths were all caused in part or entirely by FDA-approved painkillers and prescription drugs. That is the epidemic that's really haunting us in America today. Now, joining us to continue our conversation about farming in America is Mark Baker from bakersgreenacres.com. He is the Michigan pig farmer that we mentioned earlier. Mark, are you with us right now?
I'm here, Mike.
Thank you, Mark, for joining us today, man. It's great to hear from you. You're a very courageous American. Just want to give a quick background. You're an Air Force veteran. You've been a farmer there for in Michigan for, what, 5 or 6 years, something around that time?
About 8. I got out of the service in 2004.
Okay. 8 years. Okay, I didn't know that. So on April 1... you were there at your farm thinking, oh my goodness, the state is going to come murder, slaughter my herd. What actually happened that night before April 1 when that regulation was going to kick in?
Well, we got tipped off on Friday that they were coming, and I called my lawyer, and he made a few phone calls. And apparently, the attorney general in Michigan stepped in and said that there would not be any movement against us until our court case is settled. So I had some reassurance, but there's a bit of a trust issue with these guys, so I moved my family off Saturday afternoon anyway, just as a precaution. And then I stood from 12 to 12 the next day waiting, and they didn't show.
All right, so you could still be raided at any time under this invasive species order that the DNR in Michigan has actually put into place, correct? They haven't?
I suppose so. I don't see any concrete block to keep them from doing what they want to do. They've said they won't, or the attorney general has said that he's restrained them, but...
But isn't this like Obama signing the NDAA that quote, legalizes secret arrest and secret torture and detainment of American citizens, and then saying, well, I won't use it? Isn't that similar to what's really happening to you in Michigan?
It's very similar. Very similar.
So they want to claim they have this power over you, but then they say they will selectively restrain it in your case because you went public, you made a YouTube video, you have a family that it looks nice on YouTube. They don't want to obviously be seen as you know, raiding your farm. But what about all your other friends and neighbors and farmers? Are they afraid of being raided?
Not only are they afraid of it, but they're being aggressively searched as we speak. DNR has shown up at a friend of ours, Ron McKendrick, up in Sheboygan, and tried to get on his farm to inspect it. What they're looking for is probable cause. And he told him, no, get a warrant. Well, they came back the next day, and then they trespassed illegally. You know, they had binoculars, and they were looking out onto his property to see if they could see something.
So they're surveilling his farm.
Yeah, and then they parked down the road. I guess I'm told it was two trucks, and they were there for 2 days.
You would think that they would have something better to do to stake out actual terrorists, if you can even find any in America.
I suppose, but you know, this is the DNR. They are supposed to be just protecting the wild animals out in the woods and clearing trails and things like that.
Well, let me ask you this, Mark. Well, first of all, let me give out your website, bakersgreenacres.com, for those who want to read your blog, who want to see your videos, your ongoing updates, and so on. But I want to ask you, as a United States Air Force veteran, someone who put your effort, your life, your time on the line to help protect America and its values and its freedoms, and now here you are being subjected to the threat of having your animals killed at gunpoint by the state in which you are a resident. How does that make you feel?
I think it's a disgrace. Disgrace, and I think the state government here should really be ashamed of what they're allowing to have happen to their citizens.
It seems to me that there's got to be more to this also, because it's not just that they're going to back off selectively in your case. That law is still on the books. Those bureaucrats have conspired to threaten you and destroy your property and destroy your livelihood, in essence. Isn't that a crime, or shouldn't it be a conspiracy to destroy the livelihood of an honest, hardworking farmer?
Well, yeah, in reality it is. They've leveled a declaratory ruling at us that it is unconstitutional and therefore illegal. And we're duty-bound as American citizens to disobey orders that are illegal or unconstitutional. And then it's their responsibility to try and prosecute us. In the prosecution phase, it'll be found out that the orders that they have leveled are unconstitutional. And then it will turn on them, and the courts will want to know what they are doing and why they are doing this.
Are you planning on seeking justice through the legal system to hold those accountable in Michigan government who have conspired to destroy your livelihood and slaughter your animals?
Yes, we are. A group of us farmers have sued the Michigan DNR, and we probably go to court with them this summer sometime.
Have you thought about civilly filing a civil suit that names the specific individuals and attempting to hold them accountable?
Yes, we have. We sued Rodney Stokes, who is the director of the Michigan DNR.
Will you please keep me posted on the updates on that, and I'll share that information with Kurt Nimmo and the entire InfoWars team. This is the thing, Mark. It is time for the American people, especially the farmers, to stop just laying down and taking it. And I don't mean escalating into violence. I mean using the court system, using the jury system for as long as we have it, to take back the liberties, to hold these bureaucrats and these tyrants accountable when they violate the Constitution, when they violate our civil rights, and they put us in positions that leave us no other alternative but to seek redress.
That's true, Mike. There's several legal defense funds out there for farmers to use. We started off with the Farm to Consumer Legal Defense Fund, and they're the ones that got us going on this. And they're in place to protect the rights of farmers. But the farmers really have to know that a lot of this work they have to do on their own. And the first thing they have to do is think about resistance. You know, if they're asked to do something that's unconstitutional, unfair, first they have to resist. And like in our case here, the DNR, if you tell them that they can't come on, there's really nothing more they can do than get a search warrant. And I think that if they go to the judge, the county judge, and ask for a search warrant to search for illegal pigs, I don't think that's going to go over very well.
That's insane. But what we saw, what we just reported on in other breaking news today, the case with Andrew Wurdes in Roswell, Georgia, the bureaucrats there in that city, they kept pushing to try to just fabricate something or find something. They had their own culvert clogged up that ended up flooding his property to create a nuisance that they then charged him with having a nuisance property. It's like once you're on their target list, they can invoke all these ridiculous rules and even create a situation where they can cite you for a violation and then throw you in jail for having that violation.
Yeah, I guess so, but I think things are changing. I think Americans are getting fed up, and like in our case, though, people have said to me that, oh, you have a problem with the DNR. And I don't think that's the case. I think the DNR has a problem with me because we're not going to let up on this ever. You know, we're just not going to let up. They could do away with the declaratory ruling tomorrow, and we would still be on them to find out why this was done, who was behind it, you know, where the money goes. We know that they're working with Michigan Pork Growers Association, which is the concentrated animal feeding operation outfits that are here in Michigan. And those guys definitely want more market share. And so they're using the DNR to strong arm the small farms and put them out.
Let me mention the Farm to Consumer Legal Defense Fund because they have done some excellent work in this area. Their website is ftcldf.org. It's obviously the acronym for their name, Farm to Consumer Legal Defense Fund. But it seems like, Mark, what you're doing, and I really love to see your courage in doing this, is you are putting the tyrants on notice. And I think that's what we have to do across America, whether it's the farmers, whether it's the milkman in California, whether it's the backyard chicken farmer in Georgia, whether it's the front yard gardener in Oak Park, Michigan. We have to put the bureaucrats on notice and say, we will not be trampled on any longer. We have the God-given natural right to grow our own food and to not be interfered with and oppressed by local government tyrants just because they're not into farming and food.
That's right. Hey, and people got to remember, first of all, they're American citizens. There's a lot that goes with being an American citizen. There's a lot of privileges with that. And then these guys that are trying to push these unconstitutional laws down our throats, they have names, they have faces, they have careers, and they can be sued individually. And they will know that that's going to affect their life profoundly, just like they want to affect my life. I mean, they don't have a problem with, you know, doing away with half my farming operation.
Yeah, well, so, they were going to put you out of business, basically,
right.
Destroy your entire livelihood.
Well, they've done it to at least 70 Michigan farmers that have just done away with their herds just because they were afraid. And I think that they don't know who they are in being an American citizen. They have the Constitution. And, you know, people, I've heard, since this has started, I've heard people say, well, the government's just wiping themselves with the Constitution. Well, not if you don't let them.
That's right.
Your Fourth Amendment right is very clear, and they cannot trespass on you, you know, unless they have a warrant or a probable cause.
So. You seem like a very action-oriented individual, and I don't mean that in the context of an escalation, just that you're willing to take a stand for the rights that you have been granted as an American citizen and those same rights for which you have donated your time to help protect as an Air Force active duty person. What is the sense there in Michigan as you talk to others? Is there a sense of people getting fed up and I don't want to say rising up because I don't want to imply an armed resistance. I just want to say people asserting their rights against the bureaucrats who are clearly out of control. Is that happening, or are people giving up and surrendering and giving in and licking boots?
Here in Michigan, locally, there's more giving up than standing up, and that's sad. But Michigan, all right, I served in the military for 20 years, and I served with a lot of people from different services that were from Michigan. And Michigan people are very hardcore people. They're hard workers, you know, fast runners, hard-living people. But they are petrified of their government. And I come here to live. I'm from Massachusetts. I came here to live because this is my wife's home. And I'm just amazed at how fearful these people are of their government. So I can only assume that it's just been a lifelong operation of instilling fear in these people. Especially of the DNR. They're petrified of the DNR.
Well, that's part of the tactic of government, is to paint people as terrorists, to then run these giant screens in Walmart where you've got Janet Napolitano saying, be afraid of your neighbors, spy on your neighbors, watch what they do. If you see something, say something. Your neighbor might be a terrorist. They might be planting a bomb. No, they just set their purse down on the table for a second. It's not a bomb, okay?
Yeah.
But they've trained, you're right, Mark, they've trained people to be afraid of each other.
But across the country, Mike, now, that's a different story. There's lots of people that are standing up and they're saying that we are with you. And I don't mean like 100, I mean thousands. My inbox fills up 10 times in the course of the day. And it's just one after another of support. There's only been like maybe a 0.1% that has had anything negative to say about it. And it's usually because they misunderstand the law.
Right.
And they haven't really looked into it. But I'll tell you something about me. It's not the Air Force that put this patriotism in me. I'm from New England. And when I was a kid, I used to have to walk past a monument that told about a man named Nathan Howe that dropped his plow in the furrow to respond to the Lexington alarm of April 18, 1776. And my grandfather used to tell me about that. And here was a guy that let his plow over to the side, and he went back to the farmhouse, probably got his gun, if he owned one, or a pitchfork maybe, and then went to the Concord Bridge.
To help
the alarm, yeah. And that was a blockade against Boston. The British had blockaded Boston and were allowing people out to get food only if they'd surrendered their firearms.
Oh, really? Turn in your guns and we'll give you food. Well, that may be coming again in America.
Well, it looks like they're trying to control our food, doesn't it?
Yeah, that's pretty clear. No question about that. Well, look, on March 16th, Obama seized control over all farms and food and seeds and tractors all across the country. Are you familiar with that executive order that was signed?
I heard a little bit about that, yeah.
Well, it's right there in the language. It was covered here on InfoWars. I covered it as well. It's right there in plain language, and it's not some throwback to history. It's actually reactivated right now in peacetime. We got to go to a break here, Mark, but okay. We'll continue with you on the other side of this break. Stay with us, folks. There's a lot more ahead here on the Alex Jones Show. This is Mike Adams, the Health Ranger, filling in today for Alex. Hope you're enjoying the show. We got a lot more straight ahead. Stay with us.
Right now, the average family spends one-fourth of their income on food. It's time to cut your food budget in half by using the best, most affordable food on the planet from eFoods Direct. The savings from eating this food will actually help you pay your other bills. Serve these delicious meals to your family tonight for a quick and easy dinner for about $1.25 a serving, compared to over $3 a serving for any other food. This food is compact, making it easy to store some away, and will be just as delicious in 25 years as the ones you cook tonight. Is it affordable? Absolutely. The new Alex Jones Family Pack saves you up to 50% compared to other food storage companies. See the comparison at eFoodsDirect.com/Alex or call 800-409-5633. My friends, as crazy as this world is today, you'd be nuts to not get a storable food supply. Give eFoods Direct a call and order one of the Alex Jones Family Packs and test it out today. Start your journey of food independence today at eFoodsDirect.com/Alex or call 800-409-5633.
Do you know which 37 crucial food items are going to fly off the shelves when the next disaster hits? If you don't, you and your family may be without food and waiting in long food lines after a big disaster strikes. You would be surprised how many people don't have these food items right now. 123survivalplan.com has set up a For Patriots Only video with inside information on the 37 food items that will sell out first when the next disaster strikes. The video on 123survivalplan.com has crucial information you and your family need to prepare for any disaster, natural or man-made. And you won't have to be afraid of going hungry or being sent to a FEMA refugee camp. See the video that over 1 million other smart patriots have already seen in the last 4 months. Prepare now. Go to 123survivalplan.com and learn which 37 food items you should hoard. Easy to remember, 123survivalplan.com. Again, that's 123survivalplan.com.
Diesel owners, have you had enough of hard starts, poor mileage, and poor performance? The cause is stiction, a gummy residue that clings to injectors like cholesterol clings to arteries. Stiction robs your diesel engine of power, performance, and gas mileage. The answer, Hot Shot Secret.
This is Lee from Minnesota. I have a F-350 with a 6.0 diesel, and I had many injector problems and hard starting problems. After I added Hot Shot Secret, it now starts better, feels stronger, and my mileage went up 2 miles per gallon. I recommend Hot Shot Secret to anyone with a diesel engine.
Hot Shot Secret, the only oil additive engineered to remove stiction in all diesel engines. Clean from the inside out with Hot Shot Secret. Available nationwide at all tractor supply stores or call 800-341-6516. That's 800-341-6516. Or go to HotShotSecret.com. Hot Shot Secret.
powered by science.
Yeah, welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. Mike Adams, the Health Ranger, filling in for Alex today. Thank you for being with us. We've been focusing a lot of freedom issues related to farmers, food, and much more. The bigger picture, Mark Baker is joining us right now from bakersgreenacres.com in Michigan, which for some reason has been the hotbed of a lot of government assaults on individual liberties and rights. And I'm wondering what's in the water in Michigan, but I know it's probably fluoride. What do you think, Mark? What do you think about your state? Why are they so tyrannical with everybody there?
I don't know. It almost seems like Michigan is a place where they test things out. They try to see what they can do, what the people will take.
Well, and as you said, most people are taking a lot. They're putting up with it. It gives me hope on one hand to interview you, Mark, and to hear your patriotism and your courage and your understanding of the key concepts of liberty, but then you tell me these things that make me feel kind of down that a lot of people are surrendering and giving in instead of standing up. That doesn't make me feel good.
Well, yeah, if we look back in history, like especially at the Revolution, there was really only 20% of the colonists that resisted King George, and then less than 2% actually picked up arms. And it doesn't take a whole lot of people. It just depends on the fervence that's in them.
Well, you've hit upon it. That's exactly right. Alex says it all the time. A lot of people are just sitting still, doing nothing. They don't count.
No.
The revolution, as you say, was less than 5% of the population, and yet they won because they had it in their hearts. They had it in their spirit to protect their liberties. Like you, Mark, you're not just fighting for some legal precedent. You're fighting for your livelihood. You're fighting for your family, for your future.
That's right. And not just mine either, Mike, because they're going after, right now, it's heritage breeds of swine that they're going after, but they could just as easily say that certain types of beef are invasive species, or poultry that we like to grow out on pasture is invasive because it hurts the wild birds, something like that. We've actually heard those rumblings.
Oh, yeah, that's coming. But wasn't the origin of this Invasive Species Act, you actually explained this to me, was originally written by Michigan to prevent the tankers, the big ships, coming into the lake and dumping their ballast water that was full of ocean saltwater creatures that became invasive. Wasn't that the original intent behind the law?
Yes, it was. And it's a good law. We really got to protect our natural resources. Everybody knows that. But to add farm animals onto an invasive species order is just a little over the top, I think.
Well, but here's where it's going, man. You want to know where it's really going, Mark, and all the listeners out there? Where? They're going to label humans the invasive species.
Yeah.
That's what's coming. That's what was depicted in Hunger Games, that the people are the invaders, that all the land belongs to the kingship, and that humans are not allowed outside their zones.
Yeah.
Everything's a green zone. And they take your land. I mean, this is part of the story in Roswell, Georgia today. Well, let me ask you this, Mark. What's ahead for you? What's the next step?
Well, I'm actually heading up to the Upper Peninsula today, and we're going to have a little strategy meeting with a couple of the other farmers that have chosen to resist, and our lawyers, and just talk about what our next move is. There's going to be some depositions happening, and these people from the DNR, by name, will have to come in and explain the things that they have said. These are people that have gone to college and then have made ludicrous statements about how biology works.
They don't know what a feral pig really is.
Well, they do. They've said these things, but now they're going to be held accountable in a deposition forum.
All right, Mark, we're out of time. I want to thank you for joining us, though. BakersGreenAcres.com is the website where you can learn more about Mark and read his blog there. Stay with us here, folks. We'll be back with a lot more on The Alex Jones Show right after these messages.
You are listening to GCN. Visit GCNlive.com today.
$4, $5, $6, even $7 a gallon? According to fuel industry insiders and economic experts, those are the forecasted fuel prices, with no end in sight. Fight back fuel prices with a fuel saver from airfusionsystems.com. These fuel savers can save you from 20 to 40%. They're designed to fit any vehicle, from compacts to SUVs to transport trucks. The fuel saver works on all gas, diesel, even propane engines. Easy do-it-yourself installation in about 15 minutes. And the best part? No engine modifications, no computer chipping, no running wires, no chemicals, no water, no running costs, and no maintenance. And these fuel savers come complete with all parts and accessories. See how it works at airfusionsystems.com, spelled A-I-R-F-U-S-I-O-N, systems.com. Or call 888-887-9981, 888-887-9981. Fuel savers from airfusionsystems.com. Save fuel, save money, save Earth.
Waging war on corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
We're already into the third hour on the Alex Jones Show. This is Mike Adams, the Health Ranger, filling in for Alex today. Thank you for staying with us. We've already covered some fascinating ground on the issues of farm freedom, food freedom, liberty across America. We've got a lot more coming up, including an interview with Patrick Henningsen, the Infowars.com reporter, who has some breaking news for us about the escalation of the race war in America. Of course, we are here trying to de-escalate that. Meanwhile, the mainstream media and many of these other so-called nonprofits out there are actually pushing for a race war escalation. All of that straight ahead here on the Alex Jones Show. Following, well, that starts in the next segment. Also, at the bottom of this hour, in about 30 minutes, we've got an interview with Dale Carson. He's the author of this book, Arrest Proof Yourself, and he's a former FBI agent. He is a former Miami cop. A very interesting individual. I've interviewed him once before. He's got a lot of valuable information to share with you about how to avoid arrest and confront police or handle police confrontations in a way that keeps you out of prison and doesn't cause trouble. All right. So I know that we are all trying to resist tyranny, but that doesn't mean you should mouth off to the state trooper that just pulled you over. All right. That's not going to help. In many cases, these cops aren't the bad guys. All right. The cops are just doing their jobs. And some of them are actually listeners to the show. Some of them are actually quite well-informed patriots. So we don't want to offend the people, the good cops in the system that are actually trying to help us, the sheriffs and the deputies especially. You know, Sheriff Richard Mack has been educating a lot of people. We want to teach you how to properly interface with those individuals in law enforcement so that you don't tick them off and end up being punished as a result, especially if you're not guilty of anything. So stay tuned for that at the bottom of this hour. Now, I want to go to, we asked for calls earlier. We've got another caller holding. Peter in Washington has been holding. Are you still there, Peter? I want to go ahead and take your call. Peter is not there. Okay, we're gonna move on and go to Pete in Michigan, who's also been holding. Pete, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here. Can you hear me okay?
Yes, I can, sir. Go ahead.
Okay, great. I've been trying to get through to you guys for months, and I can never get past the queue stage. But just want to let you know I'm an InfoWarrior listener for 4 years now. I've been out there in the establishment space when the V for Victory campaign was going hot. I kept going after you guys ended it. Handed out over 5,000 V for Victory flyers. I even went into the courthouse and handed them out in the courthouse. Was threatened with arrest many times. Now I'm facing a challenge, and I need your help and the help of your listeners.
What do you got? Fill us in. We got 2 minutes. Go for it.
Okay, August 1st, I was in the courthouse, and I was approached by some officers, and they demanded that I turn over my cell phone. At the time, there was no law, and there was absolutely no policy outlawing or banning cell phones or recording devices at the courthouse. I refused, and I cited to them the Fourth Amendment right that I have, and I told them, if I'm breaking a law, I will leave. If I'm breaking a law, I will turn over this cell phone. It was in my pocket. I wasn't doing anything with it.
Let me guess, they arrested you.
Yeah, they arrested me. Five officers beat me up. Oh, there's security footage of it in the courthouse. They are charging me
Very quickly, because we're almost out of time. Is there a website?
They're charging me with a felony of resisting obstructing.
How do we reach you, man? How do we reach you? You want to stay on hold after this?
PT6@hotmail.com. And wait. I've been slanderized by the local media. I can't get any good publicity.
Wait, give us the email again, please. Give us the email again.
GLNPT6@hotmail.com.
Okay, got it. All right, we'll be in touch with you. We'll look into this. Pete, right? Pete from Michigan. I want to thank you for your call. I'm sorry to cut you off. We've just got a network clock to adhere to here. It sounds like you're experiencing what is a reflection of the overriding oppression and tyranny being dealt out by local tyrants and bureaucrats all across the country. Stay with us. A lot more straight ahead, including Patrick Henningsen, the reporter here on Infowars.com. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
Right now, the average family spends one-fourth of their income on food. It's time to cut your food budget in half by using the best, most affordable food on the planet from eFoods Direct. The savings from eating this food will actually help you pay your other bills. Serve these delicious meals to your family tonight for a quick and easy dinner for about $1.25 a serving, compared to over $3 a serving for any other food. This food is compact, making it easy to store some away, and will be just as delicious in 25 years as the ones you cook tonight. Is it affordable? Absolutely. The new Alex Jones Family Pack saves you up to 50% compared to other food storage companies. See the comparison at eFoodsDirect.com/Alex or call 800-409-5633. My friends, as crazy as this world is today, you'd be nuts to not get a storable food supply. Give eFoods Direct a call and order one of the Alex Jones Family Packs and test it out today. Start your journey of food independence today at eFoodsDirect.com/Alex or call 800-409-5633. I had tried everything. I'd cut back the amount of food I was eating. I was lifting weights and jogging, but nothing was working. My body was literally starving for minerals and trace elements as well as key vitamins. And as soon as I had that, I immediately could eat half of what I was eating previously and be satisfied. Now, there are hundreds of great products at InfoWarsTeam.com, but I want to point out the three that have helped me lose 37 pounds in just 2 months. Products like Beyond Tangy Tangerine, Pollen Burst, and Rebound. When I started taking the Tangy Tangerine and other products every day, I lost more than 37 pounds in just 2 months. Now that's results. I want to challenge my listeners to go to InfoWarsTeam.com and to order just three of their products, and you will see the changes in the way you look, feel, and in your appetite almost immediately. Start your journey to health and wellness today. InfoWarsTeam.com.
When you're out on the road, the last place you want to be is on the road. But if the unfortunate happens, you'll be glad you were wearing diamond gussets.
There's a place down in Tennessee where they make blue diamond gusset jeans. They sew pride in every stitch. Guarantee you love the way they fit. Put a diamond gusset in the crotch where you need it most. Blue diamond gussets got it, others don't.
We turn jeans inside out. Diamond gusset jeans, made in the USA with unparalleled quality. Our Defender motorcycle jeans combine gusset comfort with Kevlar protection, so you can ride all day with confidence. Order yours at gusset.com. Diamond gusset jeans got it, others don't.
From his Central Texas Command Center, deep behind enemy lines, the information war continues. It's Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Okay, we're back here on the Alex Jones Show. Thank you for joining us today. This is Mike Adams filling in for Alex, and we're going to be joined in this segment by Patrick Henningsen, the Infowars.com reporter who's been covering the escalation of the race wars in America. He's got a feature story up on Infowars.com right now entitled Trayvon Martin, Disinformation, Fake Reporting, Fueling the Illusion of the American Race War. And now joining us in studio right here is one of the key researchers who's been digging into the details to give us a truthful view, not the typical mainstream, lamestream media spin, but the truthful reporting on this, none other than Aaron Dykes. Aaron, hey, man. Good to have you on today.
Thanks for bringing me in.
Yeah.
Well, you know, the real reporting's coming up with Patrick because he called sources. He's found out that they're most likely not going to be charging Zimmerman with first-degree murder. Instead, his sources suggest they're going to go after that stand-your-ground thing in Florida and try to fight them on the gun rights thing overall. But meanwhile, they've been spinning this racial war thing and trying to pump it up. And he's got mainstream reports where they reported neo-Nazis marching and trying to stir things up, only it didn't happen.
It didn't happen.
But the media went with it anyway.
Okay, so wait a minute. I saw this in the mainstream media too. The neo-Nazis marching through the town with their guns. I saw pictures on the mainstream media with all their military-looking gear. You're saying that didn't happen?
Well, that's what Patrick Henningsen's reporting. He's got all the details, but it came out in a Miami blog or a Florida blog, only it was a total misreport. He called the police station locally, found out this was not going on according to their reports, and so it appears to be yet another hyped-up thing just to stir it up in the media.
All right, so we do have Patrick Henningsen joining us by Skype video. We're going to go to you, Patrick, in just a second. I know you're standing by to give us the breakdown of that story. Anything else that's crucial to give us the context for the story, Aaron?
Yeah, let me give you some background, not on the Zimmerman and Trayvon case, but on stirring up racial hatred in general in the Orlando area, the same area where this case is going on. Back in 2006, there was a neo-Nazi group led by a guy named David Gletty. He deliberately marched through the black community and tried to stir up hatred with his little clownish neo-Nazi uniforms and the flags and whatever else. I believe it was less than a dozen of them marching. They were protected by the police. The only problem is it came out a year later. He was 100% an FBI informant just trying to stir up hatred. And you know groups like the SPLC are not going to be far behind. And it's interesting that a lot of the neo-Nazis continued to defend this guy, David Gletty, who was outed in the Orlando Sentinel back in February 15, 2007. And so there they are all, you know, for years trying to stir this stuff up, trying to punch the buttons. And unfortunately, people have a tendency to fall for it. They really shouldn't. They want to divide us to keep the attention away from the oligarchy, all the looting going on in the country, and divide us amongst ourselves on these issues that I think we're outgrowing as a country.
No, you hit it with the phrase punching our buttons. They know that there are emotional buttons that can be punched relentlessly across the American population that are going to lead to a rise in hatred and violence. Now, let's go ahead and go to Patrick Henningsen, who I believe has joined us by Skype video. Is Patrick with us on Skype?
Yeah, I'm here. Can you hear me?
Okay, Mike? Awesome. Yeah, Patrick, I can hear you. Go ahead, man. What would you like to lead in with on this story?
Well, firstly, I'll preface this story with saying that I was able to get access to some people. I won't name it who the person is, but let's just say they are a judge in the Sanford court system, Central Florida court system. The reason is because as a child, I lived very close to Sanford, and my mother worked in downtown Sanford for a number of years. So we still have some links there. So I just had to go into my little black book. It's amazing that the if you look at the whole spectrum of guessing and not saying much, which the mainstream media are very good at, which is making headlines that don't actually declare something, we've gone out here and just made a few basic inquiries, and we're able to actually report something that is really going on amidst all the hype and all the race baiting and everything else, which the media seems content to go into.
So Patrick, very quickly, just an overview for those who really want to understand the context here. Who benefits from the escalation of the race war? Can you name who are the key beneficiaries in the power structure who want this to happen?
Okay. Well, the story about neo-Nazis, armed neo-Nazis running patrols in Sanford, Florida, was synchronized magically on the Southern Poverty Law Center's website at the same time it appeared in the article in the Miami New Times. Okay. We've dispelled this as a piece of fake news. Nonetheless, the liberal leaning blogs and so forth ran with it. Now, Florida has got a reputation of being, especially Central Florida, Stanford in particular, as one of the best examples of racial harmony in the state of Florida, believe it or not. And this is from long-term Florida residents who have served public office there, who have spoken to doctors, lawyers, and so forth. Now, what we have in the media is we have political opportunists who are looking for some cheap political mileage out of a racial divide, white versus black, rich versus poor, and so forth. And then you have members of the media who are basically addicted to crisis opportunity. And you can say the same thing about politicians. I'm not just talking about Al Sharpton and some of these reactionary, foundation-funded, unemployable talking heads, of which the comments made by President Obama a few weeks ago, where he said, if I had a son, he'd look like Trayvon Martin. That is basically along the same lines as what Al Sharpton's doing by having marches down there. The Southern Poverty Law Center, believe it or not, Mike, I called them directly. I spoke to the director, Mark Potak, and we had a little discussion about what was going on there. I asked about the neo-Nazis. He gave me their laundry list of events going back to Jasper, Texas with the James Byrd lynching in 98 and then Toledo, Ohio, named all the names. And I said, well, what about the new Black Panther movement? I said, what about these guys? They're calling for a dead or alive bounty on the head of George Zimmerman, and also calling for a race war on Tampa Radio, which Kurt Nimmo chronicled very much in detail in his article yesterday. I said, what about this? I said, what about hate speech? This is a quote from the Southern Poverty Law Center, and I wish Alex Jones was here. He'd be jumping out of his chair.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure.
Mark Potak said to me, there's no such thing as hate speech.
What?
There's no such thing as hate speech.
Wait a minute. He means there's no such thing as hate speech when it comes out of their mouths. But when anybody else is saying something, then they claim that's hate speech, right? So total contradiction, just as usual. That's what we keep hearing in this.
Well, according to Mark, he said it's only hate speech if there's incitement or there is what's legally termed as a true threat.
But they are inciting. They're openly inciting violence.
So and I went around in circles with him on this point. And, you know, what can I say? And they're one of the biggest attack dogs on the left as far as anti-Semitic this or calling for censorship of domestic patriot groups and so forth. The Southern Poverty Law Center, and I won't even get into the Oklahoma City bombing Elohim City incident. Alex Jones can really sink his teeth into that tomorrow. But so the beneficiaries are people who have short-term gains to make out of dividing society into its respective parts. I'm working on another longer feature, which I hope to have finished later today, but definitely by tomorrow morning, which is entitled, We Don't Need Another Race War in America. And
yeah.
What I'm saying, Mike, and you can comment on this, is this race war is a short-term warm-up phase for what's coming next, which is a class war. And that has already been seeded by the Occupy movement by using terms like 1% and 99%. And also the Black Panther movement, they're saying they want to get rid of capitalism. The new socialist neo-Nazi movement, they want to get rid of capitalism. It reminds me of the climate change conference in Copenhagen when I went and reported for InfoWars, where you had the foundation funded hippies outside wanting to break into the conference to ruin the meeting of all the corporate collectivists inside. They're collectivists on both sides.
You're onto something huge here, Patrick. Very good analysis as usual. So folks, look for that article tomorrow on InfoWars.com or maybe even later today. I want to go to Aaron here and ask Aaron to comment on these contradictions that Patrick just pointed out. We've got this contradiction where according to his conversation with Southern Law Poverty Center, there is no hate speech.
Yeah, that's huge. I mean, they do nothing but label patriot groups who have not exhibited any hate speech as hate speech groups. And then when you've got someone in a recording openly just calling for a sea of blood, that is somehow not hate speech. The larger system is what gets me. You ask who would benefit from this. Look at the way groups that George Soros handles have brought about the Arab Spring. They also brought about the action in Africa that we saw with the Kony 2012 thing. They have the groups poised to benefit from that. You've got a number of oligarchical benefactors to the Occupy Wall Street. Why? Because they want this larger world government system built on the idea of social justice, of a way to get justice. justice for groups that are not represented. But when you go back for decades, for instance, if you read Webster Tarpley's Obama unauthorized biography, you see how he's a product of a number of extremist groups who are, again, trying to punch these buttons. And in many cases, it goes back to what the Ford Foundation was trying to do, giving grants specifically to radical groups, denying grants to more mainstream groups, groups that at least are not seeking violence.
Right.
And you got people like McGeorge Bundy, the Skull and Bones acolyte, pushing these programs through big money foundations like the Ford Foundation.
Well, it's incredible. When they do it, it's okay, right? But when somebody else tries to actually de-escalate and speak out for basic justice, basic liberty, basic common law in America, they're labeled sovereign citizens, which is now being equated with terrorism. Common sense has been thrown out the window, and just the basic facts have been thrown out the window. For example, Zimmerman, he's not white. I mean, he's not a white guy.
But they want to start a race war where the average white person's a honky, but the elitist at Skull and Bones who are steering the whole mechanism, they're not a honky, you know.
We got to go to break, Aaron.
Use the term, but.
I know. No, you're using it. You're paraphrasing it.
Get along.
Yeah, exactly. Thank you, Patrick. We'll be right back. Stay with us on the Alex Jones Show. A lot more straight ahead. Stay with us.
You don't need me to tell you that humanity is in a deep crisis. Everyone can feel it. We know a tectonic struggle is now taking place between the forces of freedom and those who love darkness, bondage, and enslavement. Yes, my friends, evil is rising. But take heart. For every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. Recently, New World Order operative Hillary Clinton admitted they're losing the info war.
We are in an information war, and we are losing that war.
The globalists are scared. They've overreached. The future of the info war is in your hands. Join PrisonPlanet.tv. Download the thousands of special video reports, ebooks, and more, and get them out to everyone you know. Continue to spread the word about the broadcast on YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, and every other globalist propaganda platform. We are going to use their system against them. The info war now goes into high gear.
All whey protein powders are not created equal. Fresh liquid whey has been used for hundreds of years to restore health to the sick and youth to the aging. Why is it that no one reports these benefits from today's whey protein powders? It is because they are all processed with heat or chemicals, which damages the protein and amino acids, making them allergy-causing or toxic to your body. One World Whey's True Cool process retains all the powerful properties of fresh raw whey in a concentrated powder. My name is Stephen Heuer. As a degreed nutritionist, my goal is to make you healthy in as short a time and as affordably as possible. One World Whey is speeding up the process of helping people get healthy and is replacing the need for many other supplements, making it more affordable. To learn how One World Whey may help you with fat loss, the elimination of inflammation and pain, detoxification of heavy metals, intestinal health, brain function, and increases in strength, energy, and muscle size, call 888-988-3325 or visit oneworldway.com. That's oneworldway.com.
That's what it sounds like when a burglar kicks in the door of a dark house that looks like no one is home. Don't let your home be the next target. Make it look like someone is home watching television with fake TV. Fake TV is a small electronic device that makes the same light as a real television. So from outside, it looks like someone is home watching TV. Fake TV plugs in just like a lamp on a timer, but is far more convincing to burglars. Fake TV deters burglars, costs far less than an alarm, and is highly recommended by numerous police departments. Use it anytime you're away from home. To order your fake TV for only $34.95, go to faketv.com. Or call 1-877-5-FAKE-TV. Each additional fake TV is only $29.95. So get one for you and one for a loved one for safety, security, and peace of mind for both of you. Call 877-5-FAKE-TV or go to faketv.com. FakeTV.com, the burglar deterrent.
Are you storing food? Prepared families are storing food for months and years, but only have enough fuel stored for days or weeks. Stretch your fuel storage by harnessing the power of the sun with a sun oven. Food can be baked, boiled, or steamed at temperatures of 360 to 400 degrees with the power of the sun. You can use the sun for 50 to 80% of your cooking, allowing you to preserve your fuel storage for rainy days. Sun-baked foods stay moister and have less shrinkage and do not burn. Sun-baked roasts are tastier and more succulent, and sun-baked bread has unparalleled taste and texture. Water can be heated in a sun oven for purification or personal hygiene. For the past 26 years, sun ovens have been proudly made in the U.S. They're durable, have a long life, and come with a 100% satisfaction guarantee. Don't be fooled by cheap imitations. For a discount coupon, visit sunoven.com/radio. That's sunoven.com/radio.
Don't worry, this show is documented. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
I fell into a burning ring.
We're continuing our interview with Patrick Henningsen, the Infowars.com reporter. This is Mike Adams, the Health Ranger, filling in for Alex today, in case you were wondering. This just in, Santorum suspends GOP presidential campaign. So, Rick Santorum is out of the race, clearing the path for Mitt Romney to become the nominee. Yeah, after they stole it from Ron Paul. I mean, let's be honest about it. As long as we're telling the truth, you know, Zimmerman isn't white, and they stole the election from Ron Paul. There you go, for the record. But continuing with Patrick Henningsen, we are talking about the escalation of the race war in America, who benefits from that escalation, and why we must resist it. Because remember, our buttons are being pushed, all of us. White people, black people, brown people, no matter what your race or color, the global elite is messing with your head. If you feel angry about this whole situation, you have been manipulated. So you have to resist that, chill out, calm down, and realize that it's all about us working together as people to resist tyranny and not allowing that tyranny to make us fight against each other. Patrick, I'd like to have your thoughts on that topic, actually.
Yeah, Mike, I just want to point out that before this whole Trayvon Martin shooting media circus began, you know, things like the neo-Nazi or the white supremacist movement was just about dead and buried. You know, it was on life support system. And what the left-leaning media and the Al Sharptons and the Barack Obama and the Jeremiah Wrights of the world have done is they've resuscitated the white supremacist movement and somehow made it kind of sexy for the lowest common denominator of society. Likewise, the new Black Panther movement has no appeal to really anybody in today's modern America. But sure enough, after this circus, they've now kind of risen up to have some people listening to them, and they are getting, you know, some credence in very sort of dark and moldy circles. But, you know, this is a typical kind of controlled cutout, two sides of a cardboard cutout. You have the National Socialist Movement on one side, New Black Panthers on the other, and I will bet you the house that both of those movements have a federal informant steering their media operations and so forth.
Oh, you bet.
Right there in at the top of their organization.
Yeah.
And any Americans learn one thing from this is to understand that point.
You're exactly right. This is racial escalation theater. I'm not talking about the shooting itself. That was obviously a real event. The shooting did take place. But everything that surrounds that, the context that they're building around it, the escalation, the words that they're putting out there, the poison in the minds of the people, this is racial escalation theater taking place. Is there any other evidence, Patrick, that there are FBI informants or other sort of controllers that are steering groups, that specific details that you know of right now?
I can't say for certain, but all I can do is I can look at history and I can read these reports about the weather underground. I mean, it's quite likely, and a lot of people don't talk about this, but Bill Ayers, if you look at his MO and you look at the MO of the weather underground, Bill Ayers is anything but a radical leftist. Bill Ayers looks to me like he was a career federal informant, because otherwise he'd be in a federal penitentiary right now doing back-to-back life sentences. So let's get real. And most of these sort of radical guys who are allowed to be big media personalities are protected under the federal informant cloak, so to speak. But, you know, there's another more disturbing trend. Okay, and this is a foundation-funded thing on PBS. I watched a show called Finding Your Roots, and there was a black professor with a white and a black classroom, and they were talking about the founding fathers, and they were basically focusing on the fact that George Washington and Thomas Jefferson, and these guys were slave owners. And then they were going to the black students and saying, well, what do you think about this? And the black students were saying, well, that means they're part of the problem. You know, and we thought the Constitution was this and the Constitution was that. But these are children being manipulated by academics and foundation-funded older people to make them say, throw out the Constitution, throw out the law of the land. And that's something that this federal government and the one before it under George W. Bush, make no mistake, has been working to minimize the influence of the Constitution within the greater society of the United States applying to laws.
What's astonishing to this, to me, in all this, Patrick, is that they have taken this one event, which is tragic, of course, as any loss of life is tragic, but in the bigger context, it is tiny compared to the number of lives lost every single day by just prescription drugs, for example, or soldiers committing suicide because they're on psychiatric drugs.
Or taser guns.
Yeah, right. So it's all out of context. They don't have the priorities straight about what's really killing Americans.
We're all the victims of a police state, every one of us.
Absolutely. Patrick, I want to thank you for joining us today. Really great talking with you here. And folks, watch for Patrick Henningsen's articles on Infowars.com. We'll be right back with a lot more here on the Alex Jones Show. Stay with us. We'll be back in a couple minutes.
We're on the march. The empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Hi, folks. This is Alex Jones. I'm looking for people that have the wisdom to spot savings, opportunity, and recognize risk. Saving means to make money. The Cowbin Pure Soap Company can save you thousands of dollars and give you good old-fashioned real soaps that are triple concentrated and twice as good as what you're using now. Soaps made from vegetable and coconut oils that contain no useless dyes, perfumes, deodorants, or antibacterials. Your risk is the hundreds of hazardous toxic detergents that give you rashes, itching sores, and deteriorating clothing called lint. If you want something better, if you want something you've never had before, you have to do something you've never done before. Getting a free catalog is easy by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calvin on the web at 5starsoap.com. Take charge of your health now by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calvin on the web at 5starsoap.com. A little over a year ago, I began to do a lot of research into why, even if I had a pretty good-sized meal, that I was still starving. And my research led me to a well-known fact that most of the soils that we grow our crops on here in the United States and across the industrialized world are almost completely depleted of almost all of the key minerals and trace elements that our bodies need to rebuild themselves, fight off cancer, and be healthy. I then searched out the best vitamin and mineral company out there and discovered Youngevity. The Youngevity products are designed to give you the real nutrition you need, and once you've got that, you don't have to eat as much to be satisfied. I've lost 37 pounds in 2 months, simply getting the vitamins and minerals I need. Check it out for yourself. It's incredible. Go to InfoWarsTeam.com today and order your first canister of Beyond Tangy Tangerine Complete Multivitamin Mineral Complex Dietary Supplement. That's InfoWarsTeam.com. Right now, the average family spends 1/4 of their income on food. It's time to cut your food budget in half by using the best, most affordable food on the planet from eFoods Direct. The savings from eating this food will actually help you pay your other bills. Serve these delicious meals to your family tonight for a quick and easy dinner for about $1.25 a serving, compared to over $3 a serving for any other food. This food is compact, making it easy to store some away, and will be just as delicious in 25 years as the ones you cook tonight. Is it affordable? Absolutely. The new Alex Jones Family Pack saves you up to 50% compared to other food storage companies. See the comparison at eFoodsDirect.com/Alex or call 800-409-5633. My friends, as crazy as this world is today, you'd be nuts to not get a storable food supply. Give eFoods Direct a call and order one of the Alex Jones Family Packs and test it out today. Start your journey of food independence today at eFoodsDirect.com/Alex or call 800-409-5633.
Let me hit you with some good news in all of this. If you've been listening and you're a regular InfoWars, Alex Jones Show listener or reader, You know, things seem kind of crazy in the world out there, but the good news in all of this is that the desperation of the system shows that we are winning. Why do they have to resort to this race war escalation? Why do they have to resort to the fabrication of fake news? Why do they have to resort to the fake science, to the dumbing down, the chemical drugging, the chemical lobotomizing of our children with vaccines and fluoride and GMOs? Why do they have to do that? The answer is because we're winning. Truth is winning. Enlightenment is winning. People are waking up. You know, truth is more powerful than fiction. Light is more powerful than darkness. God is more powerful than the devil, to use that metaphor. And the information that we are uncovering here and reporting and bringing to you every day here on the Infowars.com team is the kind of information that's going to set humanity free. It's the kind of information that's going to allow humanity to attain that higher spiritual awareness and achievement, to be free from the bonds of tyranny, to be free from being enslaved and oppressed by governments and in other organizations that have operated throughout history. Of course, governments being the most dangerous of all. But light will win over darkness. Truth will win over fiction and lies and deception. And that's why they're so desperate. So when you see these tactics being used, just remember in your mind, just remember that this is evidence that we are winning the fight for true freedom and liberty and justice for all of us and our children, all our future. Now, one of the side effects of this growing police state is that we, as the free individuals of America or wherever you're listening from, we will have more interaction with police and law enforcement. That interaction needs to be handled very, very carefully in order to keep yourself out of jail, to not have an arrest record, because just an arrest record, even if you're not guilty of anything, just the record of being arrested can ruin your life. And here to talk to us about that is Dale Carson. He's the author of this book, Arrest Proof Yourself. I'll give you a little more intro here. He is a former FBI agent, a former law enforcement in South Miami. He's a very knowledgeable individual. He now runs a defense law practice in Florida, and he joins us to talk about how we can interface with law enforcement in an intelligent way that protects our rights, asserts our rights, but doesn't escalate the situation. And I believe he's joining us by Skype video. Do we have Dale on Skype audio?
We're still working on the video here.
All right, Dale. It's good to have you with us via Skype audio. Good to have you on the show, man. How you doing?
I'm doing real well. I got dressed up today, and now you can't see me, so there you go.
Well, we've got a still picture of you on there, and you look dressed up there, too, so it's all important. Good. Well, we talked about this interface with police. I think in your book, Arrest Proof Yourself, you opened my eyes. I read this book and was just blown away. You talk about how people are always interacting with police in ways that they're not even aware of. What are the most important points that people need to know right now and when they're out driving around that they may not be aware of?
Good manners.
Good manners.
Always good manners. There's no replacement for that. I think one of the keys is that as youngsters, we learn that law enforcement's here to help us. There's officer friendly, a number of groups that try to convince us that law enforcement is helpful. Now, in an absolute crisis, I don't think there's any question that they are helpful. But in anything other than an absolute crisis, they are there to put you in jail. And if you can understand that, if you can put your arms around that very concept, then you realize, and jail's a bad place. Being arrested's a bad place. If you can put your arms around that, you understand the dynamic. And then when you see law enforcement, you appreciate the fact that with little effort, they can put you in jail. That's what they're trained to do. That's what they get promoted internally based on, the number of arrests that they make. So when you see them, it should make the hair on the back of your head stand up.
Now, when you talk about these tally sheets that law enforcement uses to advance their career, and while they may say it's not a quota system, it is a tally sheet where they mark down how many felony arrests, how many non-felony arrests, and so on. You also talk about how when they are stopping your vehicle, they don't really care about writing traffic tickets. They're there to stop your vehicle to look for a possible felony arrest, right?
That's exactly right. And most arrests that we see certainly here in my law office are from car stops. I had a young fellow who was stopped yesterday. The officer walked up to the car, smelled marijuana emanating from the interior of the car. And as a result of that, he asked the individual to step out of the car, and then he began a search. Now, that's illegal. I say that's illegal. That's not permitted under current federal law, just to search someone's car without either consent or a search warrant. But as a practical matter, when that happens in the field, who's there to contest that?
Right.
I mean, the individual who's arrested certainly has a vested interest in saying, wait, it wasn't me. I never authorized the search. But of course, the courts are disinclined, as I think jurors are as well, to believe the words coming out of the mouth of an individual who's been stopped for a criminal violation. And it's odd when you think about it. We know carrying dope in the car with us, cocaine or heroin or oxycodone or roxycodone, however it's termed, we know that's illegal. People do it anyway.
But let me ask you this. Sorry to interrupt, but isn't it true that if you have a friend who is on a powerful psychiatric drug or a powerful narcotic painkiller, and that friend rides in the passenger seat of your car, and they've got their pills with them and their prescription bottle, and they drop a pill accidentally under the seat, then if you're later driving by yourself, a cop pulls you over, asks me, do you mind if I look in your vehicle? You don't have weapons, do you? You say, no, go ahead. You're consenting to a search. The cop finds that pill. You go to jail for felony possession of illegal substances, right?
That's 100% correct, yes. That's
so,
right.
So,
and so you're not going to have an explanation. You're not going to have, you don't even know it was there. So the key to this is to not consent to a search, because with absent consent, the law enforcement officer has to obtain a search warrant.
So how do you do that?
They may say at this, well, the way a search warrant's gathered is you have to take information in the form of an affidavit. You take that to a neutral magistrate, a judge. The judge looks at the information you have and then makes a determination as to whether or not they're going to issue a search warrant.
No, I mean, how do you as the driver say no politely so that you're not consenting to a search? How do you have a recipe?
I've been around for a number of years, officer, and frankly, I just can't in all good conscience consent to permitting you to search my car. So just take it on note that I'm refusing and not giving my consent to search my car.
That's all you have to say. You don't have to get all in their face.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Manners.
Right.
Manners.
Right. So you can just calmly and confidently assert your rights there.
And you could also say, you know, my attorney's Dale Carson, he has told me on more than one occasion never to permit law enforcement to search my car, and I would defer to him in this circumstance. So if you'd like to call him, please feel free.
You also talk about in your book, Arrest Proof Yourself, you talk about carrying a card that I think is a really brilliant idea, and the card has the name of your attorney, it has the name of maybe someone you know in law enforcement, it has some statements on it. Do you think, does this card really work if you present it to, let's say, a state trooper who just pulled you over?
Well, you know, Ed Ball, who was a guy who owned DuPont Corporation for many years, used to say, confusion to the enemy. And certainly if you present a document to law enforcement that is bona fide, it has stapled to it a business card from an attorney, a business card from a local police officer or sheriff's officer, all those things tell the officer that you are legitimate, that you're not a reason for concern for people or property in the area, in addition to which it's confusing. The officer's never gotten anything like that before.
Yeah.
Certainly, they're going to look at it and say, well, yeah, wait a minute. This guy goes to the same church my brother does. I'll call my brother. Maybe he's not such a bad guy. And in that way, you avoid being arrested. And that's the key. If you can complete a police citizen encounter and walk away a free man or woman, you have won. Believe me, well, you've won.
And let's get to this point, too. The police officer there on the scene in a traffic stop situation, they have a tremendous amount of discretion to decide what they wish to do with you. For example, even if you are committing some kind of a minor offense, they don't necessarily have to arrest you. Can't they also just give you a notice to appear in a court and not arrest you?
They can ignore it entirely. They could just say, don't do that anymore. How could you have been so dumb? And you just, the response from the citizen should be, you know, your officer, you're 100% correct. And I do apologize for my stupid behavior. It won't happen again. that's more likely to get you let off with nothing than getting in his face and saying, you know, there are real criminals around here, and it makes sense to me, since I am paying your salary, that you should go arrest some of those folks.
Right. Don't get smart mouth with them. There are times to be polite. Let me give out your website, DaleCarsonLaw.com. Did I get that right? Okay.
That's right.
DaleCarsonLaw.com, and the book is Arrest Proof Yourself, which is a good read. I actually read this when someone that I know in the natural health industry got arrested for marijuana possession, and they were in the process of being licensed as a medical marijuana provider but hadn't completed that, and yet they were carrying marijuana in their vehicle. They got arrested, and it really got me thinking about, wow, how does this whole system work? But let me ask you this, Dale. Many of us who are law-abiding citizens, such as myself, I've never been arrested, I've never committed any felony crime, anything like that, never been in jail even. We are not concerned about being arrested with pot or crack because we don't carry that stuff. What we're concerned about is being falsely arrested, being set up. What can innocent citizens do to avoid being falsely arrested or having a corrupt cop drop a bag of cocaine, or a TSA officer, they even admit to this, they drop a bag of cocaine in your luggage. What can we do in those cases?
Well, I don't think you can do much about a TSA officer. I mean, if you're going to fly, you know, you're just subject to their control. And that's horrifying as that sounds. But when you're in the open city, and you're just traveling around, the key is this, and you're not going to like this, but I've found it to be terribly true.
Okay.
Nothing good happens after about 10 or 11 o'clock at night. Nothing. So if you're out on the road and you're traveling around at night, okay, where police have a heightened concern for people and property in the area, you're just subject to encounter law enforcement. And it's just better not to be there. One of my ex-wives once asked me, well, you know, I need to have a gun. And I thought better of that, frankly. And my answer to her was this: you just don't need to be. If you're going somewhere where you think you need a gun, you don't need to be there.
That's a good point, too, yes.
You know, I think probably just staying out of areas where there's a high crime, incident of high crime. And the other thing is looking suspicious. Look, it's really easy when you think about it. If you put on a suit and tie and you drive a Crown Vic that's modestly colored and looks like a law enforcement car, and you're traveling 85 miles an hour, how often do you think you're going to get stopped? You got a suit and a tie on, and you're riding down a road, and it looks like a law enforcement car. You're never going to get stopped, right?
Right.
On the other hand, if you're driving down the road like a Cheech and Chong bomber
in El Camino, 1973,
are you going to get stopped? The answer is absolutely 100% of the time.
Right.
Because that's where the arrests are, right? The guy's got a warrant out for him. The buddies that are in the car are hiding weapons. I can remember stopping a car in Miami, arresting everybody, and finding under the back seat of the car literally hundreds of rounds of ammunition and four handguns. So anytime you get to stop, and that was for felony arrest, right?
Yeah.
So anytime you're with a bunch of guys in a car, it's like a six-pack, you know? You can't just drink one.
Doesn't this I'm sorry, go ahead.
No. So if you're riding around with a bunch of guys in a car that's not properly licensed or tagged, you're going to get stopped. You're going to get questioned. And if you don't have the right answers, or if there are warrants, you're going to have a problem. For example, frankly, you're riding in a car, the driver's the only person who should be displaying a driver's license. But how often have my clients been stopped and everybody in a car has got to produce an ID?
And the officer just says, everybody show me your ID?
Of course. But think about it. What would happen if one of the guys said, I'm not showing you anything. I don't have to, under my Fifth Amendment privilege against self-incrimination, I'm not showing you diddle, buddy. Pound salt. What do you think is going to happen to that kid?
He's going to get pulled out and beat.
Well, maybe he won't get beat, but he's going to jail.
I think he's going to get beat, and then he's going to get thrown in jail. and then they're going to start a race war out of it if he's not white. That's what I think.
It's a real problem with law enforcement and selective sorts of enforcement. And it's been going on. Look, we all profile. That's a shorthand for being able to survive in the world. If you're walking down a street and you see somebody hit up in an alley somewhere, it doesn't matter what race the individual is. You're going to shy away from that person hiding up in the alley, right?
Yeah.
That's profiling. So it's more situational, I think.
So you're saying I shouldn't ride my Harley with my bandana, my tattoos, my long sideburns. I mean, just to mention a stereotype, And you also talk about body work on your car. If your car looks like it's in bad mechanical condition, that's also another reason to get stopped, huh?
Yeah, of course. We had a favorite thing in Miami. You know, if you're driving down a road and your backup lights are on, that's a violation.
Oh, yeah, right.
So anything that's not right with your automobile, it causes you to get stopped. It causes you to get searched. Remember, the officer's in an elevated stance from you anyways, looking down into your car, right?
That's right.
So if you've got any kind of contraband or any questionable items in your car, you got a problem because that's plain view. And the officer has every right based on that to do what he needs to do or she needs to do.
Let me ask you this. You did a lot of traffic stops in your days as a Miami cop, I'm sure.
Oh, I loved them. I loved them? Sure. Gets the adrenaline going. You never know when you turn on your lights whether or not the guy's going to rabbit from you, flee from you.
And that's exciting.
And if he rabbits from you, everybody likes a chase, right?
Right. It's better than paperwork, man. Huh?
There's nothing better. But sliding around corners with your headlight and sirens and all that on, man, it's to die for, sure.
But that's a good point about the psychology of law enforcement is sometimes, I mean, you even describe them sometimes as sharks who are out on the roads looking for prey. Life can be boring as a cop if you're behind a desk a lot. You need a little adrenaline rush. You need a little excitement. We know the DEA loves smashing in doors of marijuana clinics in California. Isn't there an element of just, you know, really fun excitement from time to time?
Of course, that's why we do it. To the uninitiated, you seem surprised at that. Boy, it's a kick.
Yeah,
I'm
kind of surprised.
Team of guys, you all get white hats, right? And you rush into the darkness. So, yeah, of course, it's exciting, and you're on the right side of the law. You're doing what you're supposed to be doing. At least that's what we're led to believe, of course.
Right.
So there's a dynamic there that absolutely cannot be denied.
So our job as innocent citizens, then, is to not invoke that kind of adrenaline response from the officer who's interacting with us, then.
That's a fair point. Yeah, I'd say that's a fair point, yes.
Because I volunteered with police in Tucson. And I remember in the defensive tactics training there, they always said that resistance is met with force. So if you bring up force, the officer escalates it to more force. If you chill out, they will chill out.
Of course. And of course they will.
All right. We've got a lot more. Stay with us, Dale. I want to have you on the other side of this break. It's a fascinating conversation. Stay with us a lot more straight ahead here on the Alex Jones Show. This is Mike Adams interviewing Dale Carson. We'll be right back.
Right now, the average family spends one-fourth of their income on food. It's time to cut your food budget in half by using the best, most affordable food on the planet from eFoods Direct. The savings from eating this food will actually help you pay your other bills. Serve these delicious meals to your family tonight for a quick and easy dinner for about $1.25 a serving, compared to over $3 a serving for any other food. This food is compact, making it easy to store some away, and will be just as delicious in 25 years as the ones you cook tonight. Is it affordable? Absolutely. The new Alex Jones Family Pack saves you up to 50% compared to other food storage companies. See the comparison at eFoodsDirect.com/Alex or call 800-409-5633. My friends, as crazy as this world is today, you'd be nuts to not get a storable food supply. Give eFoods Direct a call and order one of the Alex Jones Family Packs and test it out today. Start your journey of food independence today at eFoodsDirect.com/Alex or call 800-409-5633.
What is the most abundant resource on Earth? Water. It's essential for sustaining life, but it's not always the most available. When disaster strikes, water quickly vanishes from store shelves, like it did during 9/11, Katrina, Japan, and in Joplin. 3 days without water and your body begins to shut down. Don't risk being without an abundant supply of water when the next disaster hits. Get a FlowJack hand well pump. The affordable FlowJack drops right into almost any well and is easy to install without having to remove the existing pump, giving you immediate access to plenty of cool, clean water. You could risk your family's health on a limited supply of stored water, or you could be prepared with the reliable, affordable FlowJack backup hand pump kit for only $3.99 complete. See how it works at FlowJack.com, spelled FlowJack.com. Be sure to spell FlowJack.com or call 855-4-FLOWJACK, 855-4-FLOWJACK. That's 855-435-6525. Proudly made in America. FlowJack hand well pumps. Peace of mind in a box.
Digestive health is the key to wellness and elimination of toxins. That bears repeating. Digestive health is the key to wellness and elimination of toxins. And Pro-EM-1 Daily Probiotic Cleanse is the key to digestive health. Pro-EM-1 is a powerful liquid probiotic, strong enough to cleanse, gentle enough to use every day. Pro-EM-1 is dairy, wheat, and soy free, contains all natural and certified organic ingredients, contains no preservatives or animal products, supports a healthy digestive and immune system, supports weight loss, improves absorption of food nutrients, aids in controlling yeast infections, is never freeze-dried, and uses three groups of live, viable, beneficial microbes to cleanse and remove toxins. Order Pro-EM-1 Daily Probiotic Cleanse at Terraganics.com, spelled TerraGanix.com, Terraganics.com, or call toll-free 866-369-3678. That's 866-369-3678. Pro-EM-1, the raw probiotic.
Riders on the storm.
Man, it's a crazy world out there, but to help us make sense of that, we've got attorney Dale Carson joining us in this final segment here on the Alex Jones Show, Tuesday, April 10th. This is Mike Adams, the Health Ranger. Thank you for joining us. And Dale, I've got an interesting question for you. You know, what about, in your book, you talk about how the biggest problem that the day-to-day criminals have is they don't show up for court. Their alarm clock doesn't work. They don't get out of bed and go to court and show up for the hearings and pay the fines and so on. And then it just escalates and gets worse and worse. But what about innocent people like James Stewart, who was a guest in the first hour of this show, where he shows up in court, he goes to court on time, on schedule to face these bogus charges because he was distributing milk in California. He's the milkman. And then he's in court one day in LA County, and then the Ventura County sheriff's people, deputies, arrest him there in the LA court for bogus financial crimes that they dreamed up in Ventura County. And he gets hauled into the system as a completely innocent victim of it. How do you even begin to try to assert your rights in those kinds of situations?
Well, it's an odd thing. In the United States, if you violate a law, you can violate a federal law, a state law, a municipal law, and you could be charged independently by each of those agencies. And what has to happen is anytime you're in trouble with the police, law enforcement, and there's a pending criminal case, you need to be in constant communication with the investigators in the other side of the case, in my opposition, the law enforcement people, and also the state attorney's office, and perhaps the U.S. attorney's office, to make certain that there are no more pending charges. The most shocking thing happens when my clients get arrested for, let's say, possession of narcotics case. Simultaneously, DEA on the federal side is working a narcotics case. They bond out on a $500,000 bond. So they've put up $100,000 to bond out $50,000. They would put up 10%. They get out, but before they can actually reach the jailhouse door, the federal government hits them with a charge. And so they're right back in jail, and they're out $50,000, right? You've got to coordinate that with your attorneys and with law enforcement to make sure those kinds of things are not going to happen. Because when they do, as you mentioned, there you are. You've already expended money on law enforcement, an attorney, fines, your bail bond, and now all of a sudden all of that's washed away. And that's just tragic.
Well, and in James' case, they slapped him with $1 million in bail. Now, what kinds of things you've seen firsthand, what kinds of things would typically earn $1 million in bail?
You know, it's interesting you should mention that. Jacksonville has probably the highest bonds of any place in the country that I know of. So I often see $1 million bonds. I had a case where a guy was an insurance fraud case, minor amounts of money he'd been charged. His bond was set at $1 million. And it's often punitive. In other words, law enforcement, those are the people who talk to the judges and get the bonds set, because typically you're not represented when you show up. So $1 million bond is not uncommon in certain of our cases. But generally, and this is particularly true in federal court, bonds are never that high in federal court. With rare, rare exceptions, most everyone goes home with basically a surety bond that's not even paid yet. In the federal side. So what it tells me is some one of your folks gets a $1 million bond, somebody's trying to send him a real message.
Oh, yeah, they were, and they did, as they tortured him and abused him in the L.A. County Jail. Look, we're almost out of time, but Dale, I want to thank you for joining us and encourage those who like to learn more from you to check out your website, dalecarsonlaw.com. This is the book, Arrest Proof Yourself, which I have read and found it to be absolutely fascinating as someone who hasn't even been in the jail system. So I was like, wow, this is amazing. Thank you, Dale, for joining us.
It's my pleasure. Thank you.
Great to have you on. And thank you for watching today. I really appreciate your support here on The Alex Jones Show. I want to thank the InfoWars crew and Alex in particular for leading such an amazingly effective organization fighting for your liberty and justice across America. This is Mike Adams, the Health Ranger. Thank you. We'll talk to you again soon. Take care.
Thank you for listening to GCN. Visit GCNlive.com today.
This is Alex Jones with five good reasons you should consider.